Visit to Tokyo, President Obama is reassuring Japan that America will rally to its side if China uses force to grab a set of disputed islands. White House correspondent Mark Smith reports.
Last fall, China upped the ante by declaring an air defense zone over the islands.
It would be a profound mistake to continue to see escalation around this issue.
Here in Tokyo, the president told reporters if China seizes islands the Japanese now administer, the Joint Defense Treaty means America will respond. Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, through a translator, was reassured.
Changes of the status quo based on intimidation and coercion will not be condoned.
Obama says the issue's the same as in Ukraine, whether big countries can ignore the rule of law and bully their neighbors. Mark Smith with the president, Tokyo.
Georgia's new and controversial gun law expands where licensed gun owners can take their weapons. Correspondent Tim McGuire reports not everyone's happy about the law.
One gun control group from outside Georgia calls it the Guns Everywhere Law. The new measure allows gun owners to carry weapons into bars and, under certain circumstances, schools, churches, and government buildings. Republican Governor Nathan Deal says the law is one of public safety.
So that people who follow the rules can protect themselves and their families from those who don't. Follow the rules.
Under the new law, religious leaders have the choice to allow or ban guns, and school boards would have the option of letting licensed employees carry weapons on school property. I'm Tim McGuire.
The U.S. Supreme Court says there are limits to the restitution that victims of child pornography can receive. Jerry Bodlander explains the decision.
In a 5-4 ruling, the justices threw out a judgment of nearly $3.4 million. It had been awarded to a woman whose videotaped rape by her uncle when she was a child was widely viewed on the internet. The justices said people who view child pornography can be ordered to pay restitution, but there has to be a limit based on what the person did and the victim's losses. Three justices said the way the law is written, the woman in this case, known as Amy, should get nothing. Justice Sonia Sotomayor said she should get the full $3.4 million. Jerry Bodlander, Washington.
Another court decision raising concerns, but as correspondent Emily Wagster Pettis reports, the Mississippi abortion law isn't expected to impact too many women, since very few abortions are performed after the midway point of a pregnancy.
Abortion access is already very limited in Mississippi. There's only one clinic that still performs abortions, and State Department of Health statistics show that only two of those were listed at 21 weeks or later. This new law probably will have very limited effect, but critics of it do say that it's unconstitutional.
The New York Police Department is getting a lesson in public relations and who controls social media. Warren Levinson tells us how the Twitter backlash blasted the NYPD.
When the department sent out a message asking Twitter users to tweet your photos with the hashtag MyNYPD, they were hoping to get a lot of feel-good pictures of civilians posing with patrol officers and maybe with police horses. But the overwhelming majority of snapshots were of a different kind of interaction. Cops wielding billy clubs on protesters, bloodying an 84-year-old pedestrian they were arresting for jaywalking, changing hearts and minds one baton at a time, read a sarcastic caption from an Occupy Wall Street demonstrator. An NYPD spokeswoman insists the open and uncensored dialogue has been good for the city. Warren Levinson, New York.
Correspondent John Milbourne reports, even though the soldier previously known as Bradley has been granted a name change, Chelsea Manning will continue serving a 35-year prison sentence for leaking classified secrets at the all-male disciplinary barracks at Fort Leavenworth.
It's an all-male facility, and as far as the military is concerned, Manning is still a man. They can call inmate Chelsea Manning as opposed to previously referring to inmate Bradley Manning. It does not change where she's housed. It doesn't mean that she will now be eligible for any type of medical treatment. She's seeking counseling for her gender dysphoria and also hormone treatments.
And that's the news for Radio VR in Washington. I'm Rick Young.
Interesting new ad campaign from Applebee's, which is encouraging customers to visit the restaurant ironically.
They're designed to attract young people to Applebee's by inviting them to ridicule its food, service, and atmosphere. Here, take a look.
What do you guys want to do?
We could go to Applebee's.
No, let's seriously go to Applebee's. Okay. Look, guys, it's grilled.
It's just like my neighborhood restaurant, only completely geographically non-specific.
Yeah, nothing like a wild time at Applebee's, right?
Applebee's. Wouldn't it be funny to go to Applebee's?
I like
Isn't that
it.
Persuasive?
Yeah.
But, you know, they're not resting on their laurels. They're adding new menu items designed to be ridiculed outright, like the fajita cordon bleu and the chicken strip explosion.
Those sound ridiculous.
I know. But, you know, so far this has been so successful that Applebee's is actually prepping a second series of ads aimed at customers who enjoy making fun of annoying young people who do things ironically.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves here, toll free, 855. Oops, no, you can't.
just that quick.
See, that's how, okay, so let me bring you up to speed here. Last night, the phone lines at the network, something drastic has happened to them, and they have not been fixed yet. So I will probably accidentally give you the toll free numbers again at some point tonight.
Multiple times.
You know, I did okay. It took me a couple breaks last night, but I ended up doing pretty well with it.
It's not like anything's changed, and you missed it this time.
Yeah, well, it has changed because now I'm out of practice.
Sleep?
For one show. So anyway, we're going to give you different numbers tonight. These are not toll-free. It is 603-435-1105. That's it's a studio line. Those lines are actually usually available. It's just we don't give them out because they're not toll-free. So yeah, if you get a cell phone, it probably isn't going to cost you anything because nights and weekends are lots of times free with cell phone plans.
We've also got Skype.
And we still have Skype. Skype's still the same username. You can contact us on Skype at username lrn.fm. And again, the not toll-free number tonight that you'll have to use if you want to get interactive with the show is 603-435-1105. And keep in mind, that's in this studio here, and we have no producer, so we'll be screening our own calls here this evening. So be patient if you're put on hold. We will get to you. Now, Thursday night, I was out for most of the show, and you had something, Mark, you wanted to have my opinion on, this Cliven Bundy racist allegations that he's a racist based on some statements that he made to the media earlier this week. And you're not on Friday nights, so I skipped talking about it last night.
Yeah.
So now here we are together on the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. And I have the comments from Cliven Bundy.
Yeah, this Cliven Bundy thing is really sort of, it's separated the nation. You know, like the Democrats are on one side, Republicans are on the other. You know, those that sort of...
You mean the ranch thing prior to his racist comments?
Yes.
Okay.
Very much so.
Well, now there are a lot of people who are abandoning him over these comments.
And the ship is being abandoned in many cases because he made some quote-unquote racist comments. Now, let's not forget that the vast majority of Americans get their news from clips and headlines.
Mm-hmm.
They don't actually investigate a story. They're just told what the story is by somebody.
Sure.
And when somebody says that Cliven Bundy has made a racist statement, then... I think that it matters. Like, what do they mean when they say a racist statement? Because racist is a term that means something. If words don't mean anything, then we don't have a language. If words mean something other than what we're told, somebody's telling an untruth.
Okay, so let's define racism.
Right.
My understanding of racism is sort of the belief that people who have a different genetic background are somehow inferior.
Correct. That is what racism means.
Yeah.
Or superior. You would, you know, believe that a person of a certain genetic background would be superior and that kind of
thing. Of course, that's just another way of saying the same thing.
Yes.
But, yeah. So the wording that Cliven Bundy, and we'll play the actual audio here because I've got the audio of his original statement that caused the big deal with the media.
Yeah.
I have a press release from the Bundy Ranch that attempts to further explain the statements. Apparently, he's been doing a number of interviews, etc. So we'll play the actual audio here. And it is not the best audio, I'd like to warn you.
No, this appeared to be him speaking out in front of some domicile or something.
He's just kind of out in the woods here, it looks like, or out in, you know, in
somebody's
the plains.
Recording it, and there you go.
And so let's just jump right into the alleged statements here from Cliven Bundy, and then we'll talk more about what what he actually said and the opinions of the hosts, which I don't know if we're going to agree on this, Mark.
We'll see.
Let's go here.
Let me talk to you about the Mexicans. These are just things I know about the Negro. I want to tell you one more thing I know about the Negro. When I go through Las Vegas, North Las Vegas, and I would see these little government houses, and in front of that government house, the door was usually open, and the older people and the kids, and there's always at least a half a dozen people sitting on the porch. They didn't have nothing to do. They didn't have nothing for their kids to do. They didn't have nothing for their young girls to do. And because they were basically on government subsidy, and so now what do? They abort their young children. They put their young men in jail because they never learned how to pick cotton. And I've often wondered, are they better off as slaves picking cotton, having family life and doing things, or are they better off under government subsidy?
Now, whether he's a racist, and there's more of the clip. We'll play the rest of it here.
I think that's the meat of it, though.
There's more, and I think it's more to play the rest of it. But okay. Whether or not he's a racist, one thing's for sure is I don't get the feeling he's ever met a black person. I mean, the example he gives is he talks about...
He's a rancher. You don't think he had any black farmhands?
He's out in the middle of nowhere. I mean, it's mostly his family, I think, that's helping him with the ranch. But anyway, it makes it sound like, you know, first of all, he puts them in the group. He puts all black people in this category of Negro, which makes him sound like a racist.
Right. Anytime you use the... Here's a little news flash for older folks, okay? Look, I understand there was a time in the past when using the term Negro was fine, a time in the past when using the word colored was acceptable. Yes, the NAACP does have the term colored in it. It's an old organization. Mm-hmm. The fact is, this sounds really racially insensitive these days.
It does, and I understand that the kind of the message he's trying to get out is that everybody's been enslaved by the system, and there's another statement later that kind of gets to that. And I understand his intentions, maybe, with that statement, but the wording that he uses reveals how this guy thinks. He thinks of people based on racial groups. Now, maybe he doesn't believe...
Don't most people think of people in racial groups?
I don't know what most people think.
We're told to think that way our whole lives. When you go into school, they ask you what color you are. When you go get your driver's license, they ask you what color you are. When you get your marriage license...
They didn't ask me that in New Hampshire.
What?
I was not asked that in New Hampshire.
Okay, well, they certainly asked me that in Florida. When I got my wedding, my marriage license, they asked me what color I was. They want to know.
That's not an excuse. Just because some people talk like this and think like this is not an excuse.
You don't think being enculturated with something?
It doesn't mean that it's okay. People who have a black skin color are individuals.
Agreed.
And to
people who have any other skin color are individuals.
Right. Everybody's an individual. And the fact that Cliven Bundy thinks of black people as this group that, oh, look, they're just sitting out on their porch. Like it sounds to me like his entire interaction, if any, with black people is driving by some welfare houses and seeing people on their porch. Does Cliven not have a rocking chair on his porch? What does he do when he's got some time off from the ranch? I understand it's probably a busy job taking care of 300-plus head of cattle. I get that, but, you know, is there anything wrong with sitting out on the porch? If you're sitting inside watching TV, is that somehow better than sitting out on the porch? But it sounds to me like that's the extent of his experience with somebody with black skin color, is having driven by and observed them from a distance. Because otherwise you would think that he would have something more to say. Like he does later on in this clip. He says really nice things about Mexican immigrants in a few moments in this clip, which what he says leads me to believe that he's actually interacted with these, with, you know, Mexican people. He has personal experience with them.
Let me give you my interpretation of what I heard, okay? I hear a person who, you know, is from a time when racially, you know, this is old-timey ways of speaking. Yeah, I get that he's putting people into racial categories. That's nothing unusual here in the United States. I prefer not to do that with folks. Don't want that done to me, but I get it. Like, I see that people are saying that. What he seems to have is a real value for family and for self-sufficiency.
Mm-hmm.
Like, those are his concerns, and his concern is that somehow welfare has stripped away the family and the self-sufficiency from a particular ethnic group. And it,
and the way to restore that is to go back to slavery?
He didn't claim that. He said he wondered if they were better off, was his only
that
claim.
That does not sound good at
it
all.
It sounds awful.
To make a statement.
It
that,
does.
And it makes it sound like he believes that all black people are on welfare, which is ridiculous.
I absolutely, they're not, by any stretch of the imagination.
So we'll come back with more here. If you've got comments on the Cliven Bundy comments on the comments. If you have any thoughts on his comments, you can reach us at this number tonight, 603-435-1105. That's 603-435-1105. Or call us on Skype at username lrn.fm. More from the audio coming up here in moments, and this is Free Talk Live. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
If you are like most people, chances are you're malnourished. Most people do not get the 90 essential nutrients the body needs to survive. This lack of nutrition can lead to all sorts of health issues. If you don't feel as good as you'd like, or if you're looking to get a jump start on a new, healthier you, Youngevity has your answer. With the Healthy Start Pack, you get all the nutrients your body needs. With all 90 essential nutrients and 115 fruits and vegetables, you get a supplement system that is antioxidant-rich and beyond compare. The Healthy Start Pack includes products backed by 40 years of science and millions of dollars in research, like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, EFA Plus 90, and OsteoFX Plus. To order your Healthy Start Pack today, call 607-739-5595. Again, that number is 607-739-5595. Once you start taking the Healthy Start Pack, you will see and feel why our motto is 90 for life.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's FFF at FFF.org.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up what you want. The number you'll need tonight, 603-435-1105. Normally, we've got a toll-free line. That will not be available for you tonight. Our Skype is available to you. That name is lrn.fm. You will need to send a contact request, and at that point, it'll be easy for you to connect with us on Skype. And again, the number tonight, 603-435-1105. We've been talking about the Cliven Bundy comments. Boy, did he really stick his foot in his mouth this week after having generated so much support from so many people across the country. He made some statements earlier this week that many have taken as racist. Were they actually racist? That's kind of the question on the table here tonight. I'm not real sure if this old gentleman is a racist, but I'm pretty sure that he does think of people in groups, and I think that's a dangerous thing to do, and we can get back into that here. He stereotypes, I think, and I think that's dangerous. That can't give you the 855 number. 603-435-1105. More with your calls coming up.
You've probably heard about bitcoins on the news. They're really sort of an exciting thing. They're the internet currency, an international currency, a currency that you can use anywhere in the world, and that's fantastic. It's interesting. And I bet you've thought about getting some. Well, how about getting some for free? You can do that. All you have to do is go to mathgate.info. There you can prove mathematical theorems and get bitcoins by going on their little treasure hunt by proving theorems. So you learn some logic, do some math, find some bitcoins. It's that easy. Even better, though, mathgate.info is designed to be used anonymously. If you wish, you needn't do this, but you can. So you can connect to mathgate.info through Tor, prove some theorems, and find some anonymous bitcoins. Why would you want anonymous bitcoins? Well, bitcoins are on a ledger. They can be attached to your name in some way if you don't anonymize them. And, you know, maybe you want to buy things on the internet anonymously. You can do that with bitcoins. So don't wait. Others are already searching for the bitcoins. Go to mathgate.info today. Join the treasure hunt. Mathgate.info.
All right, let's go to the phones and your calls and thoughts. Deirdre is on the line in Bozeman, Montana, listening to KMMS. Hi, Deirdre.
Hi. I want to say I'm 65 years old, and I know what it is to be prejudiced and not want to be prejudiced because it's kind of built into our DNA. And, like, if I'm on an elevator and there's a black person with me, I'm a little nervous. Why? I have no idea, and I feel bad about it. I don't think this guy's prejudiced. I think this guy is saying something about what we've done to the young black people. And there's more young black men in prison than young white men. And if we have enough money to put a young person in prison, we should have enough money to re-educate them. And I don't think he's prejudiced. I think he's caught in a prejudice that is built into our DNA. And I personally apologize to every colored person for having that.
I think it's an interesting answer. I don't know about the idea that it's built into our DNA.
I think she's talking about a cultural, you know, it's a cultural conversation that has matured over time. And perhaps those that were having that conversation in the past have, their maturity in this conversation could perhaps be arrested to some extent,
Deirdre?
Well, I feel like, I never... on a spiritual and moral level, ever would like to be prejudiced against anyone. However, if I'm truthful with myself, I find myself with prejudices, and I try to get them out. But, they're in there. Why would I be uncomfortable with a black man in an elevator? Or I wouldn't be uncomfortable with a white man? I have no logical explanation for that, and I feel bad that that's in me. No. I don't know how it got in me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And but to be fair with this man. I think he was actually saying, hey, let's look at what we have done. We say that we're not prejudiced. We say that blacks are free. But look at how many young black men are in prison. When I see those numbers, I feel completely ashamed of myself as a voting white person, a person that thinks black people are free, thinks young black men have the same opportunities as young white men, and I don't think they do.
Yeah, it seems like it must not be the case, right? Like the evidence shows right. That it must not be the case. Like, it must be glaringly obvious.
Yep, yeah. And so, anyway, I don't hear in his tone of his voice. I'm listening. You know, he's from kind of my generation, and I just think you find yourself with these conditions. When I see of what we've done to the Native American people, when I meet one, I'd like to start my conversation with, by the way, I am thoroughly ashamed of my ancestors. Let's start there.
You know, I feel like I want to start with, I got nothing to do with my ancestors. I've, I have never shot anybody based on their color. I have never enslaved anybody based on their color. I'd like to start the conversation with, hey, you know, here we are, some people who've got some different pigments in our skin, and let's just operate with that reality.
Hey, thanks, Deidre. I thought your call was really honest, and
yeah.
I appreciate
your glaringly
perspective
honest.
Tonight. Thanks for making the call at 603-435-1105.
Another thing I'd like to point out here is that, you know, to some extent we're talking about terminology. We're talking about the terminology Negro and talking about the terminology colored. These terms, they got baggage, right? But they can be used at the same time to
I'm sorry, that's not what all I'm talking about.
I know, but I well,
had he used the word black
to some extent.
Okay, right? But had he used the word black instead, it still would disturb me because he'd be treating all black people like they're sitting on their porch collecting welfare.
I find the terms colored and Negro to be flashing red lights, okay? Like, mm-hmm. Warning, racist ahead, right? When somebody's using that terminology, you got
to... But I'm willing to give an older person a pass on the use of the word colored. And even in this case...
Here's the little warning I'm giving older people is, just let it go. You know, here, let's upgrade to the term black. Mm-hmm. Just, we'll upgrade to that term. But look, I mean, like, the media would like me to upgrade to the term African-American, or even better, African-American of sub-Saharan African descent, right? Like, they want me to pile the syllables on until I can't even say anything anymore.
I remember we had, I don't know who it was, but there was a gentleman on our show, I don't know if it was Robert Wicks from Georgia.
Yeah.
Where we asked, what is it that you'd prefer to, how would you prefer to referenced?
Yes.
And not African-American. He chose black as the best description.
Right. I like black fine, but consider that Robert's of our generation, right? And
you could be Jamaican-American or whatever, right? Like,
you could. Jamaica's in America. The Caribbean's part of, the American.
My point being that black people come from outside of Africa.
Indeed, they do. There's no doubt about it. But what all I'm saying is Robert's from our generation, and that some generation decided to name the NAACP the NAACP for a reason, right? Like, because they didn't think the term colored was particularly offensive.
So we're going to continue here with more of your thoughts. The number is not toll-free tonight. It's 603-435-1105. Of course, you can join us on our website at freetalklive.com. If you want to get on Skype, and that's available to you, and you'll sound great when you do, just connect to Skype username lrn.fm. Again, the number is 603-435-1105. And we don't have as many lines, by the way, so if you're getting a busy signal, just be patient.
Sorry.
We'll come back to you. We'll get to you, promise. That's what we do here on this show, is we take your calls and your thoughts. Is Cliven Bundy a racist, or is he just guilty of collectivizing people and, stereotyping and putting people in groups? That's not as bad as racism. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. If you'd like to listen to GCN programs on the go, I have great news. GCN has created a Droid and iPhone application, and it's free. Just as easy as going to GCNlive.com, click on the banner, and download. Before you know it, you'll be listening to your favorite hard-hitting GCN shows, live or on demand, right on your Droid or iPhone, 24/7 and on the go. So download the Droid and iPhone app free by clicking on the banner at GCNlive.com. Thanks again for listening to GCNlive.com. Again, that's GCNlive.com.
Do good people ever want to call an attorney just to find out if they're right or wrong? But every time you think about calling an attorney, what are you forced to think about first? Money. If you could call as often as you wanted and talk as long as you need without a bill, would you call? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Free Press Publications is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary at fpp.cc, as well as weekly news in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com. The monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc and books at shop.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up whatever you want. You don't have to talk about the Cliven Bundy situation. That is what's on the table at the moment, but you can take control of the airwaves here via this number, which is different from usual. So if you've got our regular call-in line, you got that jotted down or in your phone or something like that, disregard it for this evening and use 603-435-1105 instead. That's 603, like New Hampshire, 435-1105. Also, Skype into the show, username lrn.fm.
In the last segment, I told you how you could get some bitcoins for free. This segment, I'm going to tell you, if you don't want to do math theorems at mathgate.info, you can go to cashintocoins.com, because this is, it's a great way to get bitcoins. It's easy, safe, fast, completely legal. They are a licensed money transmitter, or MSB. Money services business is what that stands for. It's inexpensive. Their rates are great. Customer service is their top priority over at cashintocoins.com. I've done a great deal of business with them, in many cases under, anonymously. They had no idea who I was. So, I mean, I'm confident in recommending cashintocoins.com. Many businesses are rather new in the Bitcoin world. Cashintocoins.com, they're getting to be kind of old on the block at this point. So go there, get your Bitcoins. Cashintocoins.com, orders under $40, carry no fee. They want people to get into Bitcoins. They want you to try it out. They want to make it easy for you. No fee,
If it's under $40, you can use a money order, check, wire transfer at cashintocoins.com.
Okay, so back to Cliven Bundy, the rancher. I guess we didn't really talk about who he is. For listeners that are not aware, Cliven Bundy has recently, with his family, been involved in some controversy with the Bureau of Land Management, where the BLM has been coming after him and his family for unpaid fees that the BLM demands for Bundy's ranch to use what's supposedly government-owned land. Now, the Bundy family argues that they've been using that land for generations, since before the existence of the BLM, and they don't much appreciate the BLM's services, so why should they have to pay for services that they don't want?
They also claim that the BLM isn't, the Bureau of Land Management isn't actually managing the land. They're failing to manage the land, and that why should they pay for a service they're not getting?
Folks came out to support the Bundys from across the country, and they actually went to the BLM and in mass managed to get them to turn over their cattle. It was this kind of heroic moment. We actually had Cliven's son on the show talking to us as he was riding back with 300 head of cattle and just kind of, you know, taking them back to the ranch. It was an amazing conversation that we had had. And regardless of whether or not Cliven Bundy is racist, I still support his right to have his ranch and to do what he and his family have been doing for generations there. That, to me, doesn't change. My opinion about whether or not he should be left alone by the government doesn't change based on whether he's a racist. Now, if he's a racist, that makes me less likely to be verbally supportive of him. If I were so supportive as to want to come down there and help him, that might make me think twice about physically going down there to help him. But I'm not really sure if he's a racist based on the comments we've heard so far.
I don't think there's evidence of that.
Yeah, I think that he kind of thinks in an old-timey manner, and I think that he speaks in a way that suggests that maybe he's stereotyping blacks, which I think is not racism. I think it's undesirable. I think it's not right. But I don't think that qualifies as racist. I think it just qualifies him as ignorant when it comes to
the very fact that
people.
We have terms like black and white and, you know, like these terms referring to people's ethnicity.
Yeah, I think that's a problem. I agree.
And these terms are pervasive.
Yeah.
Right? I'm going to go out on a limb and say that 90-something percent of people don't even consider whether or not they should use terms like this. And I get it, right? Like a good friend of mine, I call him my best friend, he is black. And it would be difficult if he was in a room full of white people to say, okay, he's the one in the violet shirt with the tan pants, right? He's the,
black, the black
guy, for God's sake, right?
Right.
You know, I mean, and I just said in a room full of white people, right? Like,
but there's nothing, that's not bad to use a description to describe somebody based on their features, their physical features. You know, he may also have a big nose, you know, the guy with a big nose, whatever. But if you, you know, if you group people together and you act as though they are all like this, you know, and that's what comes off of, to me, Cliven Bundy's comments, is that he believes that black people are a bunch of welfare queens sitting around on a porch all day. And it sounds very ignorant. That's what I would say, is Cliven Bundy is ignorant about black people. He's not ignorant about Mexican immigrants, and we'll continue with his comments here in a moment. But first, I want to get your calls on the air. We've got Danny on the line listening in Myrtle Beach to WRNN. Hey, Danny.
Hey, love the show. Appreciate you guys.
Thanks.
What I heard earlier today about how horrible this comment he made was, and the first I heard the actual clip was just before earlier on your show. What I got out of it is it sounds like he's slamming the government more than he is for what they're doing to keep people down. It's not like he was slamming the black community. He was just saying that they were better off when they had purpose, when they had something to do. Yes, slaves weren't treated right, but at least they had to work, and the family unit was a little bit more solid than now, where the government just keeps them down and the family unit's getting destroyed.
Because
it happens to white people, too. It's,
I get what you're saying, but the way it comes off makes it sound like he's never met a black person who he didn't consider was on welfare. And sounds to me like he lives off in his farm and he does his ranching and nobody lives around there. So, you know, he doesn't get out much. And when he does get out much, he's gone through a welfare housing project and saw some black people sitting on a porch. And he had some thoughts about, you know, how welfare contributes to listlessness and laziness and things like that. And that's true. I mean, welfare definitely contributes to people being lazy. And as you're saying, it contributes to white people being lazy and Mexican people being lazy. And, you know, anybody that's on welfare has an incentive to stay on welfare in a lot of cases. So, like, I get that point. But the way he spoke about it makes him sound like he thinks all black people are collecting welfare and that now they're worse off because of it. And that's certainly not true. There are plenty of people who have black skin color who are very productive members of society and who are not on welfare. And he doesn't seem to be aware of that.
While his choice of words were not politically correct, I just really don't think he was being all that massively hurtful towards the black community.
It didn't sound like he had malice.
No, it didn't sound like he was angry.
I didn't hear malice in his voice. And this is kind of one of those unfortunate aspects of sort of life in America. I don't know what it's like in other countries. I've certainly been to them, but, you know, I don't have my finger on their pulse of their culture, whatever culture is. You know, sort of when you talk about certain things, and race is one of them, somebody always has a better way to say what it was that you were going to say. Mm-hmm. Is it possible to say, is it, you know, Ian, you're agreeing that welfare destroys families. Cliven Bundy was saying that welfare destroys families.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it's sort of in the whole, as groups, right? Like, we're grouping people that receive welfare, right? You know,
slavery could also destroy a family as well.
Yeah, it was terrible for that, and I think that was the thing that was certainly ignored.
So to compare the two and suggest that maybe those folks would be better off being slaves. Seemed insensitive. And,
it's insensitive as hell.
And a huge, I mean, this guy is stepping in on landmines all over
right,
the place.
Right, well, you know, that's kind of what, yep, that's the problem.
Danny, any further thoughts you want to share?
Hey, I appreciate the time. Keep up the good work.
Thanks for the call. Appreciate hearing from you. Let's bring Colson on in Bozeman, Montana. Colson, you're on Free Talk Live.
Oh, hi, this is Colton, of course, yeah. I was coming to talk because I don't believe that he is racist. I think it's just that he is, I think he's just explaining something, and I don't think he's racist. I think he's just telling, and I agree that he has not seen that many black people, maybe because he lives on a ranch.
Colson, thank you for your call tonight. I agree. I don't think he's racist. I just think he's a very poor communicator on matters on this issue.
Not like he's been trained in communicating with the media.
Right. I get you. Hire a spokesman.
Oh, boy.
The number here is 603-435-1105. And I think he harbors sort of these old views that could use some updating. I don't agree with his views. More coming up.
Everybody wants to know, what can you buy with bitcoins? Isn't there like a Bitcoin general store or something? Well, yes, now there is, and it's at BitcoinGeneralStore.com. BitBrew and the Bees Brothers have teamed up to create a place where U.S. customers in the lower 48 can shop for, well, anything, with free shipping. What can you find at BitcoinGeneralStore.com? Bitcoin apparel, stickers, gifts, precious metals, physical bitcoins, coffee and honey, of course, and electronics and computer accessories. The folks at Bitcoin General Store are true Bitcoin believers who don't even use third-party payment processors. They get their inventory direct with Bitcoin and pass on the savings to you. Shop at BitcoinGeneralStore.com with confidence that you are supporting a real Bitcoin economy. You gotta see what they have to offer. Visit BitcoinGeneralStore.com today. That's BitcoinGeneralStore.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right. General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Copblock.org/pivothead.
To ensure that a record of the truth of police interactions exists and is accessible, we each need to film. That's why we're happy to announce the Accountability Through Transparency video contest, the winner of which will receive a pair of Pivothead sunglasses. For more information and to submit your video entry, go to copblock.org/pivothead. 1. Document with a camera a police employee exhibiting double standards or the standards we expect them to live up to. This can be done while on foot, during a vehicle stop, while submitting an open records request, etc. 2. Upload your video to your YouTube channel. 3. Fill out the form at copblock.org/pivothead by the deadline of midnight Eastern Standard Time, May 23rd, 2014. 4. The winner, chosen by contest sponsors, will be notified by email, and the Pivothead sunglasses will be shipped once a mailing address is received.
copblock.org/pivothead.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Imagine for a moment a radio program, the most personal of mediums, that reaches hundreds of thousands of people on more than 140 radio stations across the U.S. and around the world through the internet with podcasts and live streams. Imagine the advertising is affordable from $600 to $6,000 a month. Free Talk Live is that program. We will work with you to get clicks, calls, views, or sales. Email me at mark@freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and it's the live Saturday edition of the program. You can join us on the phones at 603-435-1105. That's a special number. Normally, that number works, by the way, so you're welcome to add it to your phone or whatever. Those are sort of the back lines here in the studio. Normally, our toll-free line is available, but it's not tonight, so you're going to have to use 603-435-1105. We've been talking about the Cliven Bundy allegedly racist comments. Certainly, there are plenty of people who are calling him a racist. I would not go that far. I don't believe that he is a racist, and he is saying that he is not a racist. Well, actually, we've got some more comments from him here in a moment, but I think that he is kind of stuck in this old way of thinking, in this kind of collectivized stereotyping method of thinking towards people where everybody's the same based on their skin color. That's not racist, but it is unfair. You know, it's not right to think about people that way. People should be considered as individuals. People with the same skin color are obviously a different strata of life. And so to act as though all of them are just sitting on a porch collecting welfare is totally unfair and uninformed. Now, I want to continue on, and maybe we'll do it in the second hour because we still have some more of your calls here. But I want to continue on with the audio because I think the second portion of the audio that was so offensive to people kind of redeems him a little bit. We'll get into that here in a moment. 603-435-1105. And don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Hey, if you've missed a moment of Free Talk Live, if you're, let's say, listening on the radio here tonight and you don't get the show during the week, we do 7 nights a week of live radio, and it's all available online. You can click and download as many episodes of Free Talk Live as you want from our website, and they go all the way back to late 2006, all for free. So go to freetalklive.com and enjoy. As we go to your phone calls and thoughts, we've got Alan on the line in Bozeman, Montana, listening to KMMS. Hello, Alan.
Are you loving all these Bozeman calls tonight, boys?
Yeah, you guys are great listeners out there, and participation. Okay. Appreciate that.
Yeah, we love liberty out here.
Yes, I believe it.
First off, I was going to say, I have a friend of mine that is, he's African-American, and he's white.
What does that mean to you?
Well, he's from South Africa, and he lives here in America.
I got you.
And so, you know what I mean? And he says, I'm African-American.
It's true.
And I'm like, okay, you know? And I'm like, okay, that. But you're right. It's difficult to get behind Bundy like that. He's, I would say, ignorant, you know?
Yes.
Just old-timey. My grandfather, I'm sure, he's used that term, colored people or Negroes. When you use the other N-word, then that's a pretty...
That's a harsh term.
Yeah, that's the one where you go, yeah, you're racist.
Right, and the way he used it was, he used it like the Negro, which kind of makes him sound even more like he's putting these people in a completely separate category from himself. Hey, look, man, we're all just human beings. Those people have more melanin in their skin.
Yeah. But, yeah, no, I and like you said, you guys hit it on the head. It's like, do I approve of the way he categorized this stuff? No, but am I still think that he was done wrong and he's got a leg to stand on? Yes.
Absolutely. Any other thoughts you want to share tonight, Alan?
No, that's about it. Just we love you out here in Bozeman.
Thanks for listening to KMMS out there. I really appreciate it. And if you really like the show, call up the program director during the week and tell him thanks.
Oh, it's shocking, actually. This is actually one more point I wanted to make. I've heard that, I know you guys don't like to get into conservative and liberal kind of things like that, but out here I've heard stories about big lib Democratic kind of liberals that have a lot of money are starting to buy radio stations. And we've seen that out here in Bozeman. Well, our station that you're listening to, that I'm listening to, actually, they fired the guy in the morning that was kind of a conservative guy and just kind of, beating up on Obama a little bit. And they fired him. They got some guy who's, in my terms, full-on lefty. And it's surprising that you guys are even on this radio station because I've heard they're buying up radio stations just to squash the...
Well, I've heard the opposite of this. Yeah. I've heard that the liberal syndicated liberal shows. I wouldn't be able to speak to local ones. I don't keep my finger on the pulse, but the syndicated liberal shows are kind of getting beaten up and have to
Randy Rhodes is shutting down her show.
WWRL,
the
number one liberal station in the country, gone off the air.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what's going on there at KMMS, but I can tell you this, that I'm grateful to be on, and Free Talk Live is on both liberal and conservative radio stations across the country, and it is certainly true in my observation of industry trends that liberal stations have been having a very tough time. A number of them have flipped formats recently, over the last few years.
It's not liberal stations. It's liberal big money guys like Buffett, not him per se, but people with big money. They go in there and they buy a station and kick all those like conservative guys off the radio and start putting on other people and whatnot.
But wouldn't that by definition – I guess I'm confused, Alan. Are you suggesting that a liberal with money would come in, buy up a conservative programmed radio station, and then put on liberals, which would make it into a liberal station, right?
Yeah. And we don't, liberal talk radio really fails any time it rears its head. Really.
Not always true. So that's not true. It's mostly true.
No.
Air America, crashed and burned.
Yeah, it was a disaster, but it was poorly managed.
Yes, but there are a number of left-leaning progressive talk show hosts out there who are doing well.
Tom Hartman's been going a long time.
Right, there are a handful of them, but there's not more than a handful of them. But many of the stations that had those hosts on are have flipped formats. They've gone from sort of progressive talk to, in a lot of cases, sports talk recently, and or flipped to more of a kind of traditional conservative talk. So I don't see what you're saying is happening as actually happening.
But here's
I sure hope not.
Here's one observation I would make about liberal stations generally is that I've talked to a couple of owners of these stations, and it seems like liberals don't buy the products that are recommended by the hosts the way conservatives do. Rush Limbaugh says, go out and buy a Chick-fil-A sandwich, and wham, Chick-fil-A is just flooded, right? You know, Tom Hartman says, go out and buy, I know he's got a gold advertiser or whatever, and it's harder for those stations to make the money. Conservative stations, they're advertising.
That's what I was going to say as well. I mean, they don't do well as far as like the marketing of.
All right. So I'm gonna argue against Mark here. And thank you, Alan, for your call tonight. I do appreciate hearing from you. And by the way, Free Talk Live, not conservative, not liberal.
Nope.
We're liberty.
Hello, Mike, 92.1.
We're liberty oriented, and yeah, we've got KGOE out in Eureka. We've got the Mike WXXM 92.1 in Madison, which is a big station. And the point I want to make in contrast to what you're saying here, Mark, is that some would argue that the liberal stations have a more difficult time getting numbers and ratings and thereby selling ads because a lot of them are weak signals. They're kind of third-tier stations, what they call in the business a rim shot, which is like a transmitter that's kind of just outside of a major market. So it's got a signal that'll cut into the market a little bit, but it won't cover the whole market. So, you know, if you're driving from home to work, maybe you can't hear it when you get to work, but you could hear it at your house, that kind of thing. That could make for a very difficult time in getting a foothold in a marketplace because, you know, a station like the Mike 92.1 has a good signal in Madison. And they, you know, when the mic was going to flip formats, the listeners there came out and supported the station and demanded that Clear Channel keep it as the Mike 92.1, and they did. And I can't imagine that they would continue as this radio station if they couldn't make it profitable.
I guess that
must be money there.
Okay, the point that I would like to make then is that if you like a particular type of radio, you need to do what it takes to support that particular
type
of radio.
Which means advertise and buy the advertiser. If you can afford to advertise, to advertise, and if you can afford to buy the advertiser's products, to go and shop there.
If it's NPR, you support them on a monthly basis. If it's whatever it is that you listen to, don't think that crap's for free. Don't think that the next guy is going to support it.
Which includes Free Talk Live, by the way. If you want to get your message out, you can. And you want to, you know, if you're a local business, obviously buying our national ads won't make sense for you. But if you're there in Madison and maybe you're not a progressive, maybe you're not a conservative, and you really like the liberty mindset that we have on this show, call up the radio station and say, hey, I only want to advertise on Free Talk Live. Don't give me this whole run of station thing where they put ads in every show. You could specify your ads just run during Free Talk Live.
You could mention Free Talk Live, Ian, but I don't recommend that you eat worms if you want to catch fish. If you're a libertarian type, don't just advertise on Free Talk Live. Advertise to whatever types of people you want to come into your business.
That's a good point.
So,
yeah.
You know, I mean, that's the
I
old
meant for
saw.
People that don't want to support. Feel like they're supporting.
You don't have to like
message.
Free Talk Live to advertise on Free Talk Live, and you don't have to like liberal or conservative.
But
talk
you're
to
more
advertise.
Likely to want to advertise with us if you like us. That much is true, right?
It's true.
So the number here tonight, 603-435-1105. We've got plenty of time for your calls and thoughts. If you're on hold, we're going to get to you coming up here in hour number two, which is imminent. It's Free Talk Live.
Stop harming your body with coffee from grocery stores or most chains. Start making a difference one cup at a time. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer you a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's organic, so no harmful pesticides or toxins. Shade grown, meaning less acidity and no heartburn. Try the best of the best for free. Just cover shipping. 10% of future purchases go toward helping us give the gift of human freedom around the globe with at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at freeross.org. That's freeross.org.
if there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, April 26th, 2014. Silver is trading at $19.72 per ounce. Gold is worth $1,304 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $454. Antiwar.com reports the Obama administration was critical yesterday of the Palestinian unity deal as unhelpful to the peace process, but downplayed the collapse of the talks, which have effectively been dead since late March. President Obama insisted a pause might be just what was needed to get the talks back on track, while Secretary of State John Kerry is said to be referring to the talks as in a holding pattern. The comments seem to reflect the administration's rose-colored view that has typified the whole process, with Kerry for months predicting his own framework would be endorsed and lead to a deal, even after both sides had already repeatedly disavowed the plan. Congress, by contrast, seems disinterested in the process as such, and more excited that the collapse means a new chance to stick it to the Palestinians, with Hawks saying they intend to push for a full defunding of the Palestinian Authority to punish them for the unity deal. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The Associated Press reports the Oklahoma Court of Criminal Appeals said Friday it will not delay the schedule for putting two inmates to death, paving the way for the state's first double execution since 1937. The court denied a request for a stay that had been filed earlier in the day by attorneys for Clayton Lockett and Charles Warner. They had also asked the court to find that the state Supreme Court ruled in error earlier in the week when it said the inmates are not entitled to more information about the drugs to be used in the execution. The appeals court also denied that request. Lockett and Warner are set to be executed at 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. respectively on Tuesday. In a filing with the Oklahoma Court of Criminal Appeals, also made on Friday, the Attorney General said there was no need to change execution dates because of an executive order this week by the governor, and the state was prepared to carry out the execution as scheduled in the governor's order. The Attorney General had written that barring an intervention from the Court of Criminal Appeals, the executions will proceed as scheduled. Lawyers for the inmate had asked the state earlier Friday for more information on the execution drugs. They sent a letter Friday requesting that the Attorney General's office comply with the state Supreme Court ruling they say compels it to identify and verify the drugs and prove they are unadulterated, uncontaminated, unexpired, and legally obtained. In that ruling Wednesday, the state's top court said a secrecy statute protects the identity of the source of execution drugs, but not the identity of the drugs or drugs to be used in executions. The Attorney General's office responded Friday, saying they did not agree with the interpretation of the inmates' lawyers, and the office provided all the information that is legally required. You've heard of shinybadges.com, but you need to check out the New Causes tab. Every item in that section includes a donation to a worthy Liberty project like Hoodie the Homeless. So go to shinybadges.com, click on the New Causes tab, and get yourself a quality product that not only supports the cause you believe in, but starts a conversation with your neighbors. Plus, get a free gift when you pay with Bitcoin at shinybadges.com. According to a federal lawsuit, four American Muslim men claim the FBI placed them on a no-fly watch list to try to coerce them into serving as government informants, even though none of them were a threat to aviation security. The suit claims that the FBI has wielded the threat of placement on the no-fly list as a tool to try to coerce four Muslim Americans who have no criminal records into serving as confidential informants. The government was either attempting to intimidate them into becoming informants or retaliating against them for declining its request. The complaint accuses U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder, FBI Director James Comey, and various other high-ranking government officials of creating the atmosphere in which innocent Muslims are targeted and forbidden from flying unless they are willing to serve as government spies against members of their own communities. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. In a landmark 5-4 decision issued this Wednesday, the Supreme Court ruled to allow Americans to cram cash directly into politicians' mouths. The ruling, which effectively eradicates former prohibitions against stuffing checks and stacks of $100 bills straight down the throats, ears, and other orifices of presidential and congressional candidates, is expected to fundamentally alter the ways American politicians have large quantities of money shoved right into their bodies.
In football music news this week, the 1985 Chicago Bears reunite to record their first new material since the Super Bowl Shuffle. The group says the new material will be darker and more introspective than its Shuffle-era work.
And in this week's op-ed pages, a man asks why, if God exists, doesn't he throw us like a really f***ing sweet party? In other news, an increasing number of men feel pressured to accept realistic standards of female beauty. FedEx confirms that more than 600,000 people try to mail themselves each year. And a recovering alcoholic doesn't need friends to have a good time.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can take control of the airwaves here. You can't do it toll-free. Normally, you can do it toll-free, but tonight the toll-free lines are down, and they are out. So you'll have to use our non-toll-free number, which is 603-435-1105, and apparently that hasn't been a problem for folks. People have been calling in on that line. No problem tonight. 603-435-1105, and also we've got Skype. You can Skype in to username lrn.fm. It is the live Saturday edition, and with you in the studio, it's Ian.
And Mark.
We're going to go back to your phone calls and thoughts here. The Cliven Bundy comments from earlier this week have been the main thrust of the show this evening. We've played a portion of his comments earlier. I do want to play the remainder of them and get your thoughts. I don't think that he's a racist, but I think that he is definitely a man who is ignorant about the folks that have a skin darker skin pigmentation than he does. He speaks of black people as though they're all this sort of collective, and that he basically stereotypes them. It sounds like he thinks they're all on welfare, and he even goes so far as to suggest that he wonders if they'd be better off as slaves again. I mean, it sounds really insensitive. It sounds really uninformed. I don't know. He didn't make any statements that suggested that he believed he was better than a black person, so I don't think he's racist. I just think that he's guilty of being kind of imbued with the olden ways and bad ways.
At the same time, he has a real concern for, people living a better life, having a strong family values, that kind of thing. At the same time, like he's diagnosing a problem, and his diagnosis doesn't even sound racist, right?
Yeah, I don't think he's a racist. I just think that he's insensitive and ignorant on this matter. But let's go to you with your thoughts. We actually now in our first hour. I'm just going to guess that everyone who we talked to was white. They sounded that way. And while
you're an insensitive bigot.
While I was screening this call, I asked Brian in Little Rock if he was a black guy, because he sounded black. And you responded, Brian, that you are a Negro. Those are the words that you used. Welcome to Free Talk Live.
Oh,
Well, thank you very kindly. I appreciate that. Well,
yes, sir.
I mean, if people are offended by the word Negro, then that says that there was some level of ignorance in Reverend King, because he used the word. A lot of civil rights leaders back in that day used the word.
Yep.
And it says that there is something that we know today that they didn't know, that Martin Luther King didn't know. And I don't think that's true. I don't think the word is all that bad to use. But now, with Mr. Bundy, I could not quite wrap my mind around his comment that that the federal officers are leaving with their guns. And I waited a while to kind of get his reasoning for why he thought that the sheriff there was going to take the federal officers' guns. And I say that just to say that I never did hear an explanation of the or reasoning for his comment, for that particular comment. And so it kind of led me to believe that, you know, the man might be suffering from some level of dementia, you know. And I've heard a lot being said. But, I mean, even in his analysis, there's a lot of things that he says that have some significance. I mean, the man has raised 14 children, and he took care of all his children. I know a lot of people who I meet a lot of people who have kids, black males, who have children, and they won't – I'm not saying a lot. I meet a lot. I'm not saying this represents the majority, but you meet a lot – that have children and won't go out and get a regular job because they don't want child support to take money away from their paycheck.
Yeah, but there's plenty of white guys like that too. You know, that's not necessarily a black thing.
Oh, right. I'm sure they are. You know, probably not too many Latinos, but you know, from what I see, I admire the Latino. You see him out in public, you know, and you'll see the man carrying the children and maybe see the woman walking out in front. But the father in the Latino families, at least the ones that I see, seem to be well-grounded in their role as being a father and a provider and whatnot. But, I guess there is some truth to what Mr. Bundy said. I'm not really offended by it. I think that... to hear the Attorney General say that, to claim to hide behind the racial shield and say that he's being mistreated by Congress, you know, I mean, I've never heard an Attorney General say anything remotely you can use, there's some legal basis to use drones in America. And so I think he said some things that have been kind of outlandish. And so
Eric Holder didn't claim that Congress was racist, though, did he? I mean, I'm trying to make sure I understand what you're saying.
Well, he said at Sharpton's little convention, he said that, you know, he tried to claim that he's the first attorney general that's been treated this way by Congress, disrespectfully by Congress, and you know, he said it to a black audience, and the inference was that he's being treated this way because he's black.
And you don't believe that's the case?
Not only that, I had a situation 20 years ago where I was in college, and the semester I was supposed to graduate, I was given a design project, and I claimed discrimination, and one of the people I wrote to was Eric Holder, you know. And I just say that just to say, the little black guy who would go to Eric Holder and try to get some relief or something, you know, Eric Holder, he'll ignore him just the same way.
Oh, yeah. he's a politician, and the politicians don't care about the little people regardless of the color of their skin.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, I really appreciate your comments tonight, Brian. Anything else you want to throw out there real quick?
No, I just think that, you know, that as far as Mr. Bundy is concerned, I think, you know, if anything, people ought to try to admire him for, you know, like I said, he had 14 kids and raised his kids. You know, I think there's a lot to admire about that. And,
absolutely. To some extent, this is a witch hunt by the mainstream media, I think. And I think that's, you know, that's sad. They're trying to sully his character as much as they possibly can. Luckily, it's after the fact that the government has backed down, at least for the moment. I thank you for the call tonight, Brian. Thanks for the heads up
on the. Thank you for having me on. I
I appreciate it.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. Appreciate hearing from you, sir.
Too.
Yep, very good.
Yeah,
thanks for the call tonight. All right, man. Hopefully we'll continue to be on there because I didn't even know we were on in Little Rock. I'll find out more over time.
Yeah,
thanks for the call, Brian. That's excellent. So the number tonight, 603-435-1105.
Yeah, and I think to some extent this is sort of the issue of language. Now, I don't like this whole conversation about political correctness because I think it often can be taken far too far. But to some extent, people will chase the rest of us around with a fly swatter, chastening us for the terminology that we use. And, you know, that when older folks use the term colored and Negro, it, like, I gotta admit, it clashes my ears, right? Like, that's kind of how I feel. But at the same time, you know, Brian can call in and call himself a Negro. Spike Lee can use the term Negro, and it's not loaded. I mean, I don't know where it stops and starts. I'd never use the N-word. Never. When Oprah Winfrey and Bill Cosby used the N-word, I would use the N-word, but not before that day. Because I think it's a painful, hateful word.
Mm-hmm.
But these other, like, where do we stop? And I'd hate the idea that we're getting chased to the point where we've got to say, you know, Americans of sub-Saharan African descent, because it destroys the language. When you add too many syllables on, it destroys the language.
Let's continue here with your calls and thoughts. We have Rick in Las Vegas listening on LRN.FM. Hello, Rick.
Hello.
Hey, what's on your mind?
Well, I usually don't call in for anything less frivolous, but I don't blame anybody for not knowing what to refer to. I'll say Negroes because that's really the most proper term. But
what do you mean proper? Scientific?
So many times, they've changed their name so many times, it's hard to know. They used to be...
How do you know they're changing the name?
Wait a minute. All right, Rick, hang on. I'm going to bring you back here. We can continue the discussion here in a moment. And again, it's like they... I don't think the black people got together in a big room and had a vote. All right, well, let's change it up again here,
we don't
boys.
Like this. The white people are getting too comfortable.
We need to confuse these folks more. Let's call ourselves... Negroes or whatever. We'll come back with more thoughts here.
It's a minefield.
Yeah. 603-435-1105.
Hi, I'm Lynn, and I am totally blind. Like many who are totally blind, I have non-24, a circadian rhythm disorder that can put your sleep-wake cycle out of sync with the 24-hour day. But I found out there's a new treatment available for non-24. It's called Hetlioz Tasimelteon, the first FDA-approved treatment for non-24.
The most common side effects of Hetlioz include headache, elevated liver enzymes, nightmares or abnormal dreams, and upper respiratory or urinary tract infection. These may occur more often in patients 65 or older. It may cause drowsiness, so limit your activity to preparing for bed. Hetlioz has not been studied, and it is not recommended for use in pregnant women, children, or people with severe liver problems. To learn more and to hear the full prescribing information, visit Hetlioz.com or call 844-241-2424. That's 844-241-2424.
Hetlioz is now available for non-24. Talk to your doctor today.
Sponsored by Vanda Pharmaceuticals.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
The American Psychiatric Association has issued an alarming study warning that the nation's used car salesmen are going completely insane, and in some extreme cases, practically giving cars away. The APA traces the outbreak of widespread hysteria to an apparent overstock of high-quality late-model cars begging to be driven off the lot today. Some severe symptoms include delusions, manic exuberance, and a psychotic commitment to offer the lowest prices guaranteed. Victims' families are joining together to raise awareness of this serious psychological epidemic.
The authorities found out how unbelievably low his prices were. They'd lock him and throw away the key.
You are not alone. Over half of America's used car salesmen are currently going bonkers.
Car dealers suffering from this condition are prone to project their own disorders onto others. According to Mad Max, the Car Czar's website, you're out of your mind if you're not taking advantage of these low, low prices.
This is the Onion News Network.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Our number tonight is not toll-free. It is tolled. 603-435-1105. Actually, most of you have got cell phones, so you'll probably not have to pay a toll to call us. But that number will be the number for tonight, 603-435-1105. And, of course, you can still join us via Skype. Our Skype username, lrn.fm. Don't forget to join us on our website as well at freetalklive.com, where all the features are totally free.
So, Mother's Day. Think about it. It's really, it's happening. And, you know, ladies, my experience is most mothers are ladies. I don't want to make any kind of, you know, flat, bigoted, sexist statements here. But I'm going to go out on a limb. Most mothers, ladies. Many ladies like roses. There's a great deal at proflowers.com. Now, look, roses, as we get closer to Mother's Day, roses get more and more scarce. It's one of those roses holidays. And it's not just red roses, but all color roses get scarce on Mother's Day. Proflowers.com has a great deal right now for $19.99, $20. You can get a wonderful arrangement of a dozen rainbow roses. Ian, you've got it. You got this arrangement this week.
That's right.
And it
in
looks,
the studio.
Yep, looks great. So for $20, you can get this beautiful arrangement while supplies last. This is an important statement because the people who plan ahead are going to get the roses, mm-hmm. and their mamas get the roses. Other people who wait around, their mamas don't get the roses. So. Proflowers.com, there's a microphone in the upper right-hand corner. It's blue, it's or white in a blue field, depending on where you are in the country and how you connect. So proflowers.com, you click on that microphone in the upper right-hand corner, you enter in FTL, and you get this deal that we have. And the deal is the $20 rainbow roses. They're beautiful. You can upgrade, and you get a free glass vase and chocolates for just $9.99 more. So for $30, mom gets some chocolates, beautiful roses, a beautiful colored vase, and all you have to do is go to proflowers.com, click on the microphone, use coupon code FTL, and your mother's going to love this. It'll be delivered to her when you want it delivered to her. I think that there's a little extra expense for delivery right on Mother's Day. But, you know, why not get this thing delivered early? Do it now so she has the flowers through the weekend. You don't have that rush. She doesn't get them delivered late on Mother's Day. Do it now. Proflowers.com.
All right, let's go back to Rick. He is in Vegas listening on LRN.FM. Rick, I wanted to make sure you had enough time to get your thoughts out. So go ahead.
Okay, thank you. So anyway, my point was they've used the labels of Negro, then colored, then Afro-American, then black, then finally to African-American. And you can't blame anybody for not knowing which one is to use. I met Clive last night. He's a sweetheart. He's a really nice guy. He's not. I would never perceive him as a racist or anything like that.
Well, I don't blame him. I give the guy a pass because he's old. You know, he doesn't know.
Right. I mean, I've got a lot of friends, and they call each other that are black and or whatever you want to call it, they call each other niggers. I mean, and so I laugh at them. I said, you guys are calling each other niggers, but you get mad if anybody else does. You know, it's just...
Yeah, I'm gonna dump you on those. I'm sorry. I really can't... I don't want that word going out on the air. And
I just don't like it.
I apologize about that, but I'm not going to allow that one. I'm not going to hang up on you for it,
okay,
but...
No problem.
But I hit the dump button.
Yeah, it's
that.
A reality in our world. People use the N-word. I get it. But I'm, you know, I'm just not on my show.
So I don't think that it's...
I was just saying that that's what they call each other. That's
a reality.
Yeah, some... okay, so this is the problem with... Okay, so I think what you're doing here, Rick, is similar to what Cliven did when he was making statements, using terms like they call each other that, as though, you know, all people who have black skin color use the N-word. That's not true. That's definitely not true. Some of them do. Or that they had this term, and then they had that term, and then they had this, as though there was some sort of collective decision-making process that they were going to change it up.
Whipped out their smartphones, voted on what we're going to call ourselves.
I don't
think
that's true either. I know that, and I mentioned that earlier, we had previously on a show years ago on Free Talk Live, we had a black guy on the phones, and I just asked straight up, you know, what is it that you prefer as far as a term of reference? Is it black? Is it African-American? What is it? He said it was black. But the last guy we had on a few moments ago from Little Rock said he's fine with the term Negro. In fact, he considers that to be the most accurate term. So there's not this sort of
right.
There's not this mass of black people out there that all think the same way or all have the same motivations. Everybody's an individual, and they don't all agree on things. And I think that it's you're in
right.
that same dangerous territory by using a term like they when you refer to, you know, all of these individuals.
Yeah. Now, the same could be applied to politicians. When I talk to politicians or government, I still say they.
Yeah. It's a lot easier.
Well, there we're dealing with total scumbag trash. So I don't mind you throw them under the bus all you want. Rick, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it, man.
I think Rick has revealed Ian's bigotry.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, not too many politicians that I find likable.
I get the confusion around the terms. What terms should we use? I like black. And I think the reason I like it is because it's one syllable. Let's make things easier in life,
yeah.
not harder. You know,
yeah.
I love to come back and come back and come back to, you know, American of Southern South Saharan African descent, because, you know, that's a pretty accurate statement. We really give us, you know, sub-Saharan African descent. That really kind of, you know, nails some things down for people. But I mean, I suppose we're all really ultimately sub-Saharan African descent.
Let's go to Ed. He's in Atlantic City listening to WPG. Hey, Ed.
Hello. How are you? I'd like to make a few points about this guy, Bundy. Number one, I wouldn't make him a simple farmer with a few cattle. This guy's a multimillionaire. He's got 1,000 head of cattle, and he owed money to the government for 20 years. He was in court 20 years ago. And they said he shouldn't, because of what he was doing with the land, grazing on the land, he refused to pay the government.
Well, I don't think he owed them a dime.
For 20 years they waited. They waited 20 years.
Well, but before you go on, Ed, I disagree on the premise that he owed them anything. To suggest that he owes them something suggests that there was some sort of an agreement between the two groups, and that he had violated the agreement. You know, that the agreement said that he owed them these things.
But that was in court, my friend.
No, there's never been an. He's never signed an agreement with the Bureau of Land Management.
The federal government the right to receive that money.
Well, of course, the court's going
to
do that.
Pay them. Now, another point I want to bring up.
Let me do just a short rebuttal here, because I think that
first of all, he's in a slave state.
What?
He's in a slave state.
What is a slave state?
Texas was a slave state.
He's in Nevada.
That's all that's on his mind. There were blacks that were slaves in the state of Texas.
He was in Nevada. He moved when he was 2 years old from Arizona.
That's what his ancestors had. Slaves.
Well, wait a second.
Ed, you're wrong on a fundamental point here. I'm going to put you on hold, Ed. You just hang on there. I know you got a lot to say. And I'm glad that Ed called in, because we need to have more time with him. And I want to just, Ed, hang on. We're going to bring you back here. The number is 603-435-1105. Yeah. Ed will come back here and we'll talk to you about whatever's on your mind as well. 603-435-1105. Cliven Bundy, not in Texas, in point of fact, in Nevada. This is Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Springtime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know spring is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for spring specials, including our 500 parts per million colloidal silver, all sizes on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia and Metabolic Complex, and Pro Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Warwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for spring at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and click on Spring Specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988, Herbal Healer Academy.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. You want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too. Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
We know you're out there. We can feel you now. We know that you're afraid. You're afraid of us. You're afraid of change. We don't know the future. We aren't here to tell you how this is going to end. We're here to tell you how it's going to begin. We're going back to editing the next edition of Freedom's Phoenix Digital Magazine now, where we are telling the people what you don't want them to know. We're showing them a world without you, a world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries, a world where anything is possible.
Where we go from there is a choice we leave to you. Subscribe at freedomsphoenixeasy.com. That's freedoms with an S, phoenixeasing.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You may take control of the airwaves here using our limited phone lines this evening. We don't have as many as we normally do, and we don't have the toll-free number. So you're going to have to use this number, 603-435-1105. That's 603-435-1105. With you in the studio tonight, it is Ian.
And Mark.
And don't forget, you can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features on our site. They are all for free. Now, the Free State Project's Porcupine Freedom Festival is just around the corner. Or it's going to seem that way very soon. We're about 2 months out, about 8 weeks away from the Porcupine Freedom Festival at this point. And that 8 weeks is going to go by in a flash. So before you know it, it's going to be here. And it's going to be time to join us and around 1,500 people, likely, in the White Mountains of northern New Hampshire. Beautiful location. Rogers Campground is just striking vistas. The view that you'll have from the campsite or the campgrounds are just stunning.
People know what a vista is, man.
Yes. And, not everybody knows what a vista is. That's Spanish.
Oh, God.
Anyway, it's a great time. There's a lot of people that are going to be coming out, many of whom have already made the move to New Hampshire. But the majority of the people attending the Porcupine Freedom Festival are maybe people who have yet to join the Free State Project or have already joined the Free State Project and are considering moving sooner rather than later. These are people that want to check out New Hampshire. They want to experience the community. We talk a lot about the idea of the Free State Project to move people who love liberty together. You look at what happened with the Cliven Bundy situation. When you get numbers of people together who are willing to stand up for their freedom, and I recommend standing up in a peaceful manner, people who are willing to stand peacefully for more liberty, they have real influence. They can make a difference, and that's what's happening here in New Hampshire. Liberty-minded people are coming here, and they're getting active, and the Free State Project's Porcupine Freedom Festival is kind of a showcase of that community. It gives you a taste of what life could be like year-round, when you're actually in physical proximity to people who understand what freedom means. If you know what freedom's all about, and that is it's your right to live your life how you want, so long as you don't hurt anybody else, and that if you want to be free, you have to allow others to be free. These are the kind of the two important tenets of the concept of freedom to me. If you get that, if you get those ideas, you're going to love the Porcupine Freedom Festival because you're surrounded by people who agree with you. And you may not agree on all the issues, but you agree with the general premise that the state is not our friend. Go to porkfest.com, P-O-R-C-F-E-S-T.com. It's June 22nd through the 29th. Free Talk Live will be there broadcasting live every single night. Again, June 22nd through 29th. Tickets are $60. Those are the Porkfest tickets. You'll still have to take care of lodging and or campsites as well. So go to porkfest.com, learn more, and we'll see you there. As we continue here, the Cliven Bundy comments. By the way, Ed dropped off the line a few moments ago. He said he had a few points to make, but I guess he didn't want to make them that bad because he didn't hang on through the break. But your calls welcome, 603-435-1105. Before we go on with your calls, I wanted to address one thing that Ed said a little bit further because he didn't really stop talking, so we didn't have a chance to really discuss it with him. But he was upset that the Bundy family hadn't paid what they, according to Ed, owe the federal government. And I don't agree they owe the federal government a thing. First of all, anything the federal government has, they took by force. The lands that they claim are theirs, whether it's out west or in your state, the federal lands, those were all taken by force or the threat of force. That's the way government operates. They take things by threatening you with violence. That's how they do business. And it's an insult to business that they even call it business, but regardless, they took that land by force, but they took it after the Bundy family had been using it. The Bundy family has been there for generations, They've been grazing that their cattle been grazing that land since before the existence of the Bureau of Land Management. So even
they've certainly been there for decades. What did the Bundy say? We had Ryan Bundy on the show. Did he say they'd been there for generations?
I don't recall.
Right.
But I've heard that they've been there since before the BLM.
Right. I've heard the story that they've been there since the 1870s, but I've also heard that story disputed that they've only been there since the 1950s, when the Cliven Bundy's family moved up when he was like two I mean, it was the 40s. I don't know. Thereabouts. From Arizona.
Okay, let's say it's not true. I still don't care because
still
I think
before
the
creation of the Bureau of Land Management, and it was.
I didn't know when they were created.
Yeah, as I understand it.
When was it that they were created?
I'll go ahead and look that up just to make sure.
But I don't care. Even if it was after the BLM was created, I don't believe the federal government has any legitimacy whatsoever. I see them as a gang of criminals that is ruling over our lives, and anybody that stands up to them in a peaceful manner, as the Bundy family did. I support. I don't support the way he's talking in this video that we played some of it for you earlier. And I do want to play more from this video, but I also want to get to your calls and your thoughts here. So Wolfgang is on the line in Nevada. And Wolfgang, you are on Free Talk Live.
Hey, a couple of months ago, the New York Times did a telephone interview with the great libertarian philosopher Walter Block. It was like a one-hour interview for a hit piece they were doing on libertarians. Mm-hmm. And they put one sentence in that interview in the article, and it said that Professor Walter Block thinks that slavery wasn't so bad. The slaves got to sing songs and pick cotton. So all they printed. So I thought, instantly I thought, well, I wonder what the whole context of that whole discussion was and what he really said, you know? Instantly that was what I thought. Likewise, with this Cliven Bundy thing, I'm thinking that we get this one-minute clip that you're all watching, and there's another three-minute clip. But what's the whole context? Why was he talking about Mexicans, black people? What was that all about? I've not heard anybody seem to be interested in this.
Well, we have the three-minute clip here.
I
don't have a one-minute clip.
But there's a 60-minute, the whole beginning to end.
Have you seen the full footage, or are you wondering what the context is?
No, I've seen it. Yes, I've seen it.
So what is the context?
I was wondering. You must be asking yourself, why is he talking about black people at all, right? Well, I'll answer it for you. If you watch the whole thing, he starts out, first of all, he says, like he always does, he begins, he says that the federal bureaucrats should be disarmed. That's his main issue. And you should love that, since we're all against standing armies, and he seems to understand that in a libertarian sense. So that guy three calls back that said he was demented, no. He's one of the very few people who understands that concept. But then he went and said, he looked out at the crowd and he said, look at y'all, you're all white. He said, why don't we have more brown people here, Mexicans, black people? He started, Chinese, he mentions. He was trying to be inclusive in his own bumbled way.
Right, bungled. I think bungled is a good term to use here, especially when you use Chinese to refer to people from Asia.
Nobody seems to care why he was talking about black people. Not one person have I read in any forum or watched the whole thing, try to get a sense of what he was trying to say there. He was trying to say we should all be in this together, and he talked about the Mexicans did it in a way that would just totally piss off 90% of all these conservatives that we kind of put up with.
Yeah, I'm going to play those.
We got it. We're ready to play it. It's just, been call after call.
So I just, my only point is try to understand what his point was. He wasn't talking about blacks for just to talk about blacks. He was trying to say, and play the interview of the black guy who's out there defending him, who was on Alex Jones. You must know about that.
Well, I don't have that. I don't know what that is, but we already had a black gentleman.
Free Talk Live is a show
tonight.
About calls. It's not about sort of pushing
a message. I'm just saying mention the fact that there's a tons of black people supporting this guy. Like I would.
Well, I don't see any reason to do that. We had a
That's argumentum ad populum.
We had a black gentleman call in, and he gave his thoughts, and they were good thoughts. So there you go, Wolfgang. Well, thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you, and thanks for the context there. 603-435-1105. We continue with Dave listening to KZNU in St. George, Utah. Hello, Dave.
Hi.
Hey, you're on the air.
Hey, first of all, I want to say I think you guys are great, and you're truly citizens of the United States of America that was formed at one time.
Well, I disagree. There's no evidence that I'm a citizen, but I appreciate that you enjoy the show. A citizen is somebody who owes a duty of allegiance in return for an obligation of protection, and because there is no obligation for me to be protected, I have no obligation of allegiance. And our music bed's going all over the place there. I imagine it'll be coming back shortly. Stand by, Dave. We're going to bring you back here in moments for more Free Talk Live. 603-435-1105. And we'll take your calls about what you want here on the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact and helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends. To prove just how good it is, we're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox Coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com.
Mother's Day is right around the corner. If you haven't ordered your Mother's Day flowers yet, make sure to visit ProFlowers.com for an amazing deal. ProFlowers has a Mother's Day special for radio listeners. Get 100 gorgeous blooms for mom with a free glass vase for $19.99. And if you want to make her day even more special, upgrade to a premium vase and add gourmet chocolates for just $9.99 more. Mom will be so happy when she unwraps her beautiful bouquet of blooms, guaranteed to stay fresh and beautiful for at least one full week. Each time she looks at her Mother's Day flowers, she'll think of you. But hurry, this deal expires soon, so make sure to place your order today. The only way to get this incredible deal is to go to proflowers.com/radio right now and enter the code PLOW, P-L-O-W, proflowers.com/radio, code PLOW, P-L-O-W. That's proflowers.com/radio, and enter code PLOW, P-L-O-W.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free This is Free Talk Live, and it is the live Saturday edition of the program. We are here with no toll-free line tonight. The number is 603-435-1105. There's some problems, technical difficulties at our network. Thankfully, though, we've got phone lines here in the studio, or it would be a very, very lonely show tonight. Just be you and I talking. Mark and I, you know, even though I enjoy a conversation with you, I enjoy conversating more with the
conversating?
Listener. The listener, those
of you. At
this point,
I feel like I'm no longer conversing.
In the audience. People in the, are you saying conversating is not a word?
Conversating is not a word.
It is now, buddy.
No. Sorry. No. I quit.
All right. Nice knowing you. So anyway, 603-435-1105 is the number here. The phone lines are loaded up. We're going to continue with you and your comments. Also, want to let you know about ProXPN. They are the ones who bring you, normally they bring you our toll-free lines. Tonight, they're bringing you the not toll-free lines. And what they really do is they bring you great private communications on the internet. It's an encrypted service, meaning they encrypt your data before it even leaves your computer, before it reaches your internet service provider. It's a virtual private network, and it's global. And the price is pretty amazing. $5 per month. That's when you use our discount code FTL20 and buy the annual plan at proxpn.com/FTL. So they protect you by encrypting your data, which means your internet service provider will no longer be able to know what you're doing. Right now, they're probably logging every website you visit and all the search terms you enter, and they may be keeping those logs for up to 5 years in some cases. You can stop that from happening tonight by going to proxpn.com/FTL. Doesn't matter what operating system you're running, Windows, Mac, iOS devices, Android devices, even Linux. There's a process for Linux users. It's pretty simple. It's a little different, though, from the other operating systems. But whatever it is you're running, you can use ProXPN, most likely. ProXPN.com/FTL. Go get started with a free account right now. When you're ready to upgrade to the premium package, you'll get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can connect to. You can actually privately torrent with ProXPN's premium package. And all you need is our discount code to get that 20% off the price of the premium account. The code is FTL20. The website is proxpn.com/FTL. And again, that code FTL20. There's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN doesn't keep records of your online habits. Again, proxpn.com/FTL. Go upgrade your internet connection's privacy at proxpn.com/FTL. As we go back to the phones and the fun, Dave is with us still in St. George listening to KZNU. We were short on time in that last segment. Dave, go ahead with your thoughts tonight.
That's good. Well, I think people should understand that Mr. Bundy has lived in a very rural part of the country all of his life. He's ranched cattle to help feed us, had very little interaction with our societies as they vary across the country. But I think the context of what he was trying to say is that people on welfare, people who are accepting doles from the government, are no better than slaves because they're becoming slaves to the government. And to get up and fight for your freedom and not continue to be a slave.
Yep. All government assistance comes with strings attached. There's no doubt about it.
Right? Absolutely.
Right. You know, the government makes these beautiful roads. And this is just one example, right? They make the beautiful roads that you can go high speeds on. It's awesome. But the right to travel has been diminished. Now driving's a privilege. At one point, it was a right for a man to travel. Now driving is a privilege.
I can understand the argument that that you're making, although I'm sure the counterargument would be that it's a lot more comfortable to sit on a porch all day and collect a welfare check than it would be to be out in a field. So, you know, maybe it's not being maybe being on welfare is better than being a slave, just depending on what you value in life.
Well, I suppose you could look at it that way. I certainly wouldn't. I don't owe anybody a thing.
You might think differently if there was a taskmaster breathing down your neck with a whip and a horse.
I think everyone would agree here that chattel slavery stinks, right? This is what occurred in the United States for 100 years prior to the 1860s.
And it sucks to be a, welfare addict as well, but I don't know if it's worse.
But the slavery that Mr. Bundy was talking about was not that slavery of the taskmaster with the whip.
Sure sounded like it.
It was a euphemism for what people are doing today.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah,
in his comments, it didn't have that sound.
I heard the man talk. Okay. I was there, and I heard him talk.
This particular
speech?
He
wasn't saying anything bad. He was trying to make people understand that this is a fight for our freedom.
I understand.
I heard no malice in the man's voice. Don't want to make it seem like that's what I heard.
I understand the point he was trying to make, and I've got their press release here that we can read if we get a chance. I get that, but he was absolutely talking about old school slavery. I mean, there's no doubt that that was, to me at least, the words I heard him say. And again, you know, if he needed to clarify, then it sounds like he's done that since then. I don't think that he's a racist. I just think that, you know, it could have been stated more clearly for today's audiences. And I think you're right. He's lived out on this ranch. He's been sort of shut off from society, and he doesn't know the right
terms. Sheltered, yeah. He's sheltered.
Hey, thanks for your call tonight, man.
And that's where the confusion comes in.
Dave, I appreciate the call and the clarification from your perspective. I appreciate hearing from you. Our number is 603-435-1105. Let's go to Carl in Atlantic City listening to WPG. Hey, Carl.
Thanks for taking my call.
No problem.
I heard about it yesterday. Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, we got you fine. Go ahead.
Okay. I heard a friend of mine called me yesterday morning, and he went off about it. Everybody's distancing herself from Bundy and all. And I said to him, Glenn, look, you know how news people are. They take bits of things, and then they make it sound like what it isn't. So I said, let me get on the computer. I fired it up and turned the speaker up, and he heard it. Because, see, Glenn's blind, okay? And then he heard the whole thing. And I forgot they asked Mr. Bundy a question first. That's why he was saying what he was saying. And I understand. I mean, there's so many. Now, Glenn was never on welfare. His family wasn't. Glenn wasn't. One of his daughters is a lawyer. Okay.
Who's Glenn? So I'm sorry, I'm lost.
Glenn's his friend who's blind and black?
Well, see, Glenn is black, and I never mention someone's race. We're all a part of the human race, and
right.
I only bring that up if somebody asks me for a description. Okay, but the thing is, he heard it, and he kind of agreed with me. Mr. Bundy kind of meant when they were on the plantation, they were a family unit is how we took it. Okay, and our government under Lyndon Johnson and whatever give the welfare to people, and there's a lot more people that are white that are on welfare than black people. And it's sad when there's three generations of that going on, you know. We understand that. But Mr. Bundy, he certainly could have said it a different way, you know, they didn't learn how to pick cotton today or some nonsense, he said.
The cotton comment really was not helpful.
No, definitely not.
No, it was not. Well, I think he kind of meant that they aren't learning a trade. I think that's what he kind of meant.
Cotton picking is a mitigable trade at this point.
Machines handle that.
Eli Witt's creation of the cotton gin, and it's hence then evolution. But I think that there's a great deal of value in many, sort of communities for hard work. And I think that value, I'm going to say I grew up in the white Anglo-Saxon Protestant community. I don't claim a race for myself. I don't think we even know.
Race.
I don't think we know what our races are.
I like the human race answer.
Is a good one. But
human race is, yes.
Thank you, Carl. I appreciate your call tonight.
Waspy sorts, they love this hard work thing. We got to work harder and get more done. And, you know, to some extent, I think to their own diminishment. But the largest part, I think hard work works for you.
Let's continue. We've got Tim, I believe, in Hampton, Virginia, listening to WNIS. Tim?
Yeah.
You're on the air.
Okay. Yeah. I was listening to everything y'all were saying about Clive Bundy and the money he owes, and actually Clark County bought up all the grazing rights back in the 90s. So how can the government claim that he owes them money when the grazing rights, in fact, belong to the county and the state?
Well, the rule with being the government is you can do whatever you want to do because you've got men with guns who will back it up. So they can claim whatever they want to claim, even if it's not legally true, and they can enforce what they want to enforce because usually they can get away with it because most people don't know how to challenge it or can't afford or don't have the time to challenge it. So basically they just do what they want.
Well, true, but the other thing about this is, all right, you've heard about Harry Reid's son representing a Chinese company that wants to put in a solar farm.
I've heard those conspiracies. I've heard those conspiracy theories, and according to Ryan Bundy, he didn't have any evidence that they were true.
Oh, really? You know,
so we asked him about it.
That's one of the problems with trying to find the facts in this case. There's so much bull crap that you can't find the flowers, you know, anywhere. Nothing.
Tim, thanks for your call tonight, man. I do appreciate hearing from you. We're going to continue on here. Hour number three next. Still time for your call. 603-435-1105.
There's a treasure hunt going on at mathgate.info, a Bitcoin treasure hunt. You can find Bitcoins by proving theorems. So learn some logic, do some math, find some Bitcoins. Even better, mathgate.info is designed to be used anonymously. So connect to mathgate.info through Tor, prove some theorems, find some anonymous Bitcoins. Don't wait. Others are already searching for the Bitcoins. Go to mathgate.info today and join the treasure hunt. There are anonymous Bitcoins to be had for the taking at mathgate.info.
Lumber Liquidators once a year hardwood flooring clearance sale is going on now. This is the biggest flooring event of the year with 5 days of historic hardwood flooring deals like top quality clearance flooring for just 19 cents a square foot, gorgeous Aberdeen birch engineered hardwood, and even horizontal natural bamboo for just $1.49, plus more deals at your local store. So go to lumberliquidators.com right now and find the store nearest you. But hurry, their famous April sale ends Monday the 28th.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, April 25th, 2014. Gold opened today, $1,302. Silver opened to $19.75, while Bitcoin is trading at $451. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Bitmain Technology, creators of the Antminer S1 180 GigaHash Bitcoin miner. No pre-order, ships on time. Sometimes it's early. Buy yours today at bitmaintech.com. Support also comes from Affordable Sound, CD and DVD duplication, along with posters and promotions materials. Online, affordablesound.com. Or call them up, 512-459-5253. And support comes from Voice and Exit, maximizing human flourishing through radical innovation. Tickets on sale now. Get 10% off with promo code FREEDOM. June 21st at Austin Music Hall. Get yours at voiceandexit.com. In the news, sweeping changes regarding gun laws in two states this week. In Georgia, Governor Nathan Deal has signed legislation into law that will allow guns to be carried into bars, churches, and government buildings. The Los Angeles Times reports the Safe Carry Protection Act takes effect July 1st. In Kansas, meanwhile, Governor Sam Brownback has signed into law legislation making it legal statewide to openly carry firearms. At the same time, the Associated Press reports the legislation strips local governments of their gun-regulating power. The change takes effect July 1st. Vermont is poised to become the first state to enact labeling for foods containing genetically modified organisms. On Wednesday, the Vermont House voted 114-30 in favor of the bill, while the state Senate approved the measure last week. The law also sets up a special defense fund to fight off expected lawsuits from food manufacturers and biotech companies like Monsanto. The measures go into effect July 1st of 2016. Students in California will have their yearly standardized testing and reporting exam replaced by Common Core, a national curriculum backed by Obama's Education Department. Some educators are calling the new Common Core tests confusing and developmentally inappropriate. Check out thelibertybeat.com for the full report. to learn which states have banned the curriculum. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Dorothy Erminger at Capstar Lending. Dorothy can walk you through the ins and outs of buying a home. Give her a call, 512-343-6494, or apply online. Call Dorothy.com, NMLS 216624. Support also comes from My Magic Mud, all-natural teeth whitener. Go to MyMagicMud.com to hear a short interview with Dr. Griffin Cole at MyMagicMud.com. And support comes from Brave New Books, online at BraveNewBookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, April 25th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. According to a report by Rolling Stone magazine, President Obama has already decided against permitting the Keystone XL pipeline. The news came in a recent article discussing the president's looming decision on whether to allow the northern leg of the pipeline to cross into the Canadian border. As of last week, it was announced by the State Department that the president would not make a decision until after the fall midterm elections. Last Friday, Oregon Senator Ron Wyden, California Governor Jerry Brown, Klamath Tribal Chair Don Gentry, and members of the Klamath Basin Task Force signed a controversial agreement that deals with water management for the planned Upper Klamath Basin in southern Oregon. The Upper Klamath Basin Comprehensive Agreement is designed to help relieve water rights disputes in the area. However, members and descendants of the Klamath, Modoc, and Yahooskan tribes state they had less than a month to review the 93-page document. The tribal members say they were cut out of the negotiation process, the agreement does not represent their cultural values, and the elected tribal officials do not have the authority to make decisions for the entire tribal membership. And Apple's latest proposal puts the technology giant in charge of individual choice. That's revealed in a published patent that outlines a driver handheld computing device lockout system. According to The Guardian, that means texting while driving would be disabled, along with other certain functions of an iPhone when the user is behind the wheel. The patent indicates that the phone would use onboard sensors to know when the vehicle is being operated, locking out the text function of the device. The patent was filed in 2008, but only published on April 22nd. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Mass Appeal Printing, your source for anything printed since 1972. Now accepting Bitcoin online, massappealinc.com. And support comes from growyourowngroceries.org. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, April 25th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting.
From Betty Davis's first role as a piece of chocolate cake in the 1931 film Palmy Days to the discovery of Niagara Falls in 1996, The Onion looks back at this week in history. On May 16, 1929, the first Academy Awards were handed out in categories such as Greatest Achievement in Blackface, Best Catholic Whipping Scene, and Most Gorgeous Gams on Abroad. The highlight of the night occurred when Wings won the award for Best Picture without a single Dago, Tar Baby, or Wetback. And on May 15, 1940, the first McDonald's opened in San Bernardino, California, back when a young Grimace was just working as a cashier. And that was what happened this week in history. As Martin Luther King Jr. once said, history is actually pretty racist.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the third hour of the program, this program being the live Saturday edition. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And things are a little different this evening on Free Talk Live. And what I mean by that is our toll-free lines are out of operation for tonight. So you'll have to call if you want to join the conversation, 603-435-1105. That's 603-435-1105. And many people have done so thus far tonight. We've gone through well over a dozen calls at this point. We're going to continue with your thoughts. The Cliven Bundy situation is still on the table for discussion. And before we go with more calls, because I have a feeling if I just keep taking calls, we're going to go all the way to the end of the show, call after call after call, because people have a lot they want to share on this particular subject. The subject being the conversation that he had with the media earlier this week, where he had some remarks that I think are best described as inept, insensitive, and possibly ignorant as well, displaying some ignorance about people who are of a black skin color. And we played some of his comments earlier. I don't think it rises to the level of racist, but it definitely is bumbling.
We had a caller call in and said that he listened to the entire hour-long clip. I can't say I invested that time with this. I felt like I heard what I heard in this three-minute clip was, you know, somebody using old-timey speak, mm-hmm. using terms like Negro and colored, which are certainly out of fashion. At one point, they were acceptable. Now they're not.
Well, it depends who you ask. We had a black gentleman call earlier tonight who was totally fine with the term Negro, and but he didn't sound old.
The guy who called in claimed that in this longer clip that Cliven was complaining that he didn't have more people of color supporting them in presence. So, like, he was bemoaning the lack of a cultural melting pot. Now, that obviously, glaringly not racist.
So, and I don't think he is a racist, and I think that, again, I think he's just maybe ignorant about black people, because it sounded like his sole experience with them was driving by a house that was kind of a welfare house and seeing folks sitting out on a porch and then drawing conclusions about that, about it sounded like all black people, and then following that with statements about how maybe they'd be better off if they were slaves again really sounded insensitive. And, you know, some have pointed out that, well, the point he was making is that we're all slaves, and certainly there's an argument to be made there. I think that it's certainly true that slavery has expanded to include absolutely everybody, and it's much more of a subtle slavery today than chattel slavery was in the past.
I've heard it described as little s slavery as opposed to big s slavery.
Yeah. The slavery that we have today, the slaves take care of themselves. They are, they have to find a place for themselves to sleep, and then they,
free range.
They give a portion of their earnings to master, and the master is the state now instead of a man with a whip or whatever. So I want to continue with his comments, and then we'll get back into your phone calls, because I think that the second portion of his comments, so the first portion he talks about black people and reveals himself as completely ignorant about black people, puts them all in the same category, puts them all, treats them as though they're all the same, and of course that's nonsense. Not all black people are on welfare. That's a ridiculous statement. There's plenty of successful black people and people that are making good lives for themselves, and they're definitely better off today than they were as slaves. So he makes his comments about black people, but then he goes on to make some comments about Mexican immigrants, which I thought were very interesting. So we're going to play those now. Here we go.
Yeah, they didn't get no more freedom. They got less freedom. They had less family alive and their happiness. You can see in their faces they weren't happy sitting on that concrete sidewalk. Down there they were probably growing their turnips.
He's still comparing the welfare house folks with people growing turnips under slavery.
So that's all government. That's not freedom. Now let me talk about the Spanish people. I understand.
And by Spanish people, he means Mexican immigrants.
Not people from Spain.
Right. I doubt he's met very many Spaniards. Mm-hmm. I think he's talking about Mexicans here. Let me go on with the clip.
That they come over here against our Constitution and cross our borders.
Okay, well, that's something that, as Will Grigg points out,
he's kind of he's kind of pointing out that he's heard that. He's not.
No, he's acknowledging that he thinks it's against the Constitution, and obviously I disagree with that point. I think that the this country was formed with the idea of bringing immigrants here.
Well, there's nothing in the Constitution about citizenship in the bill when it was written.
Right.
So if you're
he's wrong
about an original intent, the first sort of anti-immigration laws weren't until the 1870s. That's 100 years.
Yeah, so he's wrong about that point. But then he goes on and he's very, very right. I like the rest of what he says here. So here we go.
But they're here and they're people. And I've worked beside a lot of them. Don't tell me they don't work, and don't tell me they don't pay taxes.
Mm-hmm.
And don't tell me they don't have better family structures than most of us white people. When you see those Mexican families, they're together, they're picnicking together, they're spending their time together, and I'll tell you, in my way of thinking, they're awful nice people. And we need to have those people join us and be with us, not come to our party.
Now, I can't disagree with the statements that he's made there. And, of course, he's also categorizing all Mexicans as though they all have good family life. That's probably not true either. But you can tell he's had experience knowing people who are Mexican immigrants. He's worked beside them. He knows their work ethic. He's seen them interact with their families. And
this
he has
truly is what destroys racism is, you know, and even insensitivities and prejudices and all these other terms that people just use sort of interchangeably that mean different things.
Experience.
Right. You know, full on experience. Just, yeah. Oh, goodness, this isn't what I expected at all.
Yeah, I just thought that was really powerful. I'm, you know, I don't know how many of the media outlets that were focusing on his statements about black people allowed that part of the clip to be played, because that really shows that, you know, he doesn't seem like a racist at all. He acknowledges these are people. They're here. These are good people that in his experience, you know, and he's had positive experiences with these people. It sounds to me like the only experience he's had with black people is looking at them from afar, you know, sitting on a porch of a welfare house. And I imagine that if he'd had more of an experience working with black people, he'd speak differently about them too. So again, it's the second part of that clip that really leads me to believe that Cliven Bundy is not a racist. He's never made any statement in that I've seen that suggests that he believes that he's superior because of the color of his skin or anything like that. It's just that he's not a good communicator when it comes to talking about black people. Let's go on with your calls and thoughts here. I believe we have David here in Columbia, South Carolina, listening to The Point. David, you're on Free Talk Live.
I thank you for the opportunity, and I also thank you for the forum that you allow or give us an area to speak.
Sure.
I'm a 58, almost 59-year-old African-American.
Okay.
However, when I write, I normally, and speaking of us as a group, I normally say the Negro, and I don't believe that it's relative to my age. It's just my exposure, if you will.
All right.
As far as Mr. Bundy, I have no issue with him at all. I actually feel sorry for him, in a sense, because he's speaking out, if you will, beyond his demographics, and so he's not understanding, and he's also, because of that, not being understood. Mm. I heard the second part, if you will, of his statement as far as when he was speaking of the Mexicans. When I heard the first part, I had an issue, but not a big issue. I had to think about it. And then I heard the second part, and that gave better dynamics. And it's like, this man is not angry at anybody in particular as far as race is concerned. And I'd be thrilled to hear the entire thing that this one caller referenced, the 60 Minutes. Mm-hmm. And I wish that we all would, you know, give each other more time for clarity.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, the media jumped all over him, and obviously there's certain people with an agenda who wanted to take his quotes out of context and not give him the chance to clarify. So I agree. Great points tonight. Anything else you want to share, David?
Yes, with regard to the government, I have no issue with our government, with our federal government. I have more of an issue, if you will, with the state government, and because of my heritage. It was many times the federal government that came to our rescue, the rescue of my forefathers. And I'm more leery, if you will, of the local governments because
I'm leery of all strangers who have. I'm leery of all strangers with guns and cages and who will use them on me and my friends. Thanks for the call.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact in helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends to prove just how good it is. We're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox Coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw for free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this, right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it, and once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
Immigrating to the Shire was easy. I was instantly plugged into a community of individuals who also care about peace, liberty, and justice, and are willing to do something about it.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you looking for camping, hunting, survival, or shooting gear? ManVentureOutpost.com carries the name brands you want at the lowest prices. Ammunition, knives, firearm accessories, archery, air guns, scopes, binoculars, laser sights, tactical flashlights, fish finders, and boating equipment. ManVentureOutpost.com is family-owned and has the lowest prices. Go check it for yourself. Get it quick. Get it from ManVentureOutpost.com.
Now buy firearms at ManVentureOutpost.com.
Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. You may take control of the airwaves here. Now, the super majority of the show so far has been about the Cliven Bundy comments that he made earlier this week. Some were calling him a racist. I don't think that's a fair statement to make. I understand why people feel uncomfortable about the comments he made, because they were very uncomfortable in the way that he kind of spoke them. But I think that ultimately he's just not a good public speaker, that he doesn't know the right things to say, the right way to say them, and I think that he probably is guilty of thinking about people in groups rather than as individuals, which, you know, is a problem a lot of people have, and it's something you really have to pay attention to.
I think the vast majority of people.
To fix that. If you want to fix that way of being, that way of speaking, then you have to pay attention to how you speak and try to be more deliberate about communicating. I think that he, you know, miscommunicated. Maybe he's ignorant on, you know, the lifestyle of many people who are black, because it seems like he thought that a lot of them were on, you know, a lot of black people are on welfare. And I don't know if that's an accurate statement. I don't think it is. I think there's a lot of successful people out there, and a lot of folks who are, you know, in the middle class and upper class that are black.
That's... Sadly, there's more and more people on every kind of government assistance these days with the economy being turned down.
More and more people of all skin tones. So we can continue with his comments. He went on to say nice things about immigrants, and it seemed that he's had more experience knowing people who were Mexican immigrants than knowing people who were black. And I think that's probably the root of the issue, not that he's actually a racist. We'll continue with your calls coming up.
And one thing we know for sure is all these people have mothers. The lucky ones...
No matter the color. Yeah,
yeah. Sure. And the lucky ones' mothers are still alive. Mm-hmm. I can tell you that there's nothing that somebody whose mother's passed away would love more than the opportunity to give a wonderful gift to their mother on Valentine's Day. This is an opportunity you've got if your mother is living, and I want to let you know about proflowers.com. If you go to proflowers.com, there's a microphone in the upper right-hand corner. You click on that, use coupon, you know, just enter in FTL. You can call it coupon code if you want, but enter in our FTL, and they've got a great offer there. They got a lot of great offers, but the offer that I'm previewing here is a dozen rainbow roses for $19.99. That's a dozen rainbow roses. We had them delivered here to the studio. They're beautiful.
And some of them are green.
Yep. You get a free glass vase, $19.99. Now, you can go bigger and double those colorful roses with plus a free glass vase and chocolates for $9.99 more. Mm. So for basically $30, mom gets some chocolates, some great chocolates, and some beautiful roses, and it's a wonderful thing.
It's $30 plus shipping, but it's still a heck of a deal.
You know, the shipping changes depending on exactly the day you ship them, how close you get to Mother's Day. That's why
I'm
telling everybody.
You order sooner, you get a better deal on shipping.
That's why I'm telling everybody. Well, also, do you think they're going to have roses 2 days before Mother's Day?
Don't bet on it.
Now's the time to do it. And you know what? Ship ahead so mom has it all throughout the weekend.
That's a good idea.
And that's when she wants it. So that there you go. And if she's at work, have it delivered when it's at work. Get it in on Monday morning.
There you go.
Make
a scene.
That's what you're going to want to do. So go to proflowers.com. Use coupon code FTL to get this great deal. There are lots of great deals there that you can browse through. If you have
maybe mom doesn't like roses.
Well, if you have any trouble finding it, just search rainbow under us and you'll find it. Just to make sure. So there you go.
Oh, it'll come up, I think, as the featured buy for you. It shouldn't be a problem. Code FTL at proflowers.com.
The thing is depending on where you are geographically, different things can happen on this website.
Mm-hmm.
So
I got you.
That's why I'm letting people know.
Okay, so let's continue with your calls and thoughts. Michael is in Virginia Beach, actually, listening to WNIS. Hi, Michael.
Hi. Listen, let's cut to the chase here. What Mr. Bundy needs to understand is that China wants his land, and that Senator Harry Reid's son is China's broker in trying to get that land, and he stands to earn millions and millions of dollars.
Now, is this a new thing? Is it, Michael, because people have called about this conspiracy theory, are you suggesting this has been going on since the early 90s, or is it only recently that this alleged Chinese group is looking for the land?
Well,
and what's the evidence
Malachi Martin wrote about it in 1990, and he made it very clear that there are three groups in competition for one world government. One of the groups is the Kremlin, the Soviet Union, the Russians. The second group is the Vatican, and the third group is the Wall Street capital.
Okay, but what's the evidence that...
Sounds like the aliens and the Freemasons are the only ones who are left out.
Is the what is the evidence that this Chinese company is supposedly making a move for the Bundy Ranch?
Well, the fact that his son... they want as much land as they can get out there.
Okay, what's the evidence for it?
Well, the solar farms, that's what they want it for.
Okay,
they're in the solar farm business.
Let me ask you this. So Nevada is, next to Alaska, the state that the federal government owns the most land of, as a percentage of the land, not as land size. So why in the world do they need this grazing area that Cliven Bundy has when they've got the whole state? I mean, Harry Reid, Speaker of the Senate Majority Leader, can presumably, if he can get Cliven Bundy's land, he can get any land he wants. Mm. It's already owned by the federal government. Go take a look, you know, search map of federal land in Nevada, and you will see that the vast majority of the state is federal land already. Why do they care about this guy's grazing land?
Thanks, Michael, for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you, and let's go on here because
Ryan Bundy said that this wasn't He wasn't aware of this.
Ryan Bundy, it's Cliven's son. He was on our show a couple weeks ago on Saturday night, and he made it clear that we asked him about this, and he said that he had not seen any evidence.
There's so many boogeymen in this world. We don't need to make them up.
Right. The government's just bad because they're bad. I mean, they just want to take this man's land because they're jerks.
Well, they want these management fees or whatever. He claims that the
they think they own these people.
Well, they think they own everything. Right. They don't think they own the land inside the borders of the United States. They think they own the land everywhere.
Right.
I mean, the fact is that they'll, you know, what they can't get by bribing other nations, they'll invade to get.
All right, let's continue with Robert listening in Tallahassee to WVFT on the FM band. Hey, Robert.
That's true with every government.
Do we have Robert still? Robert in Tallahassee. Going once. Robert in Tallahassee, going twice. All right, well, let's try John in Birmingham. John, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yes, sir. I'm just outside of Birmingham somewhere. Actually, your call screener was one of the nicest call screeners I've ever talked to, by the way.
Aww.
And I've been calling radio stations for a while. I actually haven't called that many, but the times I have.
You must be dealing with some really rude call screeners out there. I mean, I just asked you. It was me, by the way. Thank you for that.
Well, he didn't ask me. Some call screeners, you know, want you to describe in detail what you're going to say.
Isn't that ridiculous?
Well, Free Talk Live, that's not our policy. Hopefully none of our call screeners do that. Have you ever called Free Talk Live before?
No, sir.
Because this particular call screener, is bedraggled, needs a shave, doesn't even...
Just because you need a shave doesn't mean you can't be nice to folks.
Can't even string words together. No, actually, my main co-host here, Ian, answered your
question. Yeah, I'm actually doing all the call screening tonight for Free Talk Live, which is unusual.
Hey,
stand by. Stand by, John. We're going to bring it back here in a moment. I want to make sure you get a chance to get your thoughts out here, and I appreciate the comments. Call screening, it's tough in the business. A lot of times they're trying to keep people out.
Yeah, that's their job.
We're coming up.
Do you owe the IRS money that you can't pay? Are tax liens and levies ruining your life? Are you tired of being afraid just to go to the mailbox? If this describes you, then Dan Pilla can help.
Hi, I'm Dan Pilla, and I've been solving tax problems for more than 30 years. In fact, I wrote the book that made it possible to negotiate settlements with the IRS, and I've helped thousands of people do exactly that. Call now at 800-346-6829 to learn how I can help you. You know your IRS debt will not go away by itself, but you don't have to live in fear anymore. New changes to IRS policies will help more people than ever before eliminate their debts once and for all. There's no need for you to suffer another day with IRS debt. Call 800-346-6829. I can help you eliminate wage and bank levies, release tax liens, and negotiate a settlement with the IRS that will put your tax nightmare behind you forever. Call 800-34-NO-TAX or go to my website, taxhelponline.com. That's taxhelponline.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
MindThings.com is a fun online game that pits you against people around the world to mine for scarce resources. Do business in a capitalist economy with virtually mined gold, tax-free. It doesn't require a big-time commitment. Your little mining robot guy works whether you're logged in or not. It costs nothing to play, but you can buy bonuses. They even accept bitcoins. Go to MindThings.com, use coupon code FTL, and double your mining speed. It's free. MineThings.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
There is no such thing as attention span, according to Jerry Seinfeld, who figures that people have an infinite attention span if you are entertaining them. Hey, he's kept us from channel surfing for several decades, and now he's making more millions as a Las Vegas headliner. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're looking for work. So choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Avoid redundancies such as added bonus, advance warning, end result, prior history, or personal belongings. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live. Bring up anything here on this Live Saturday edition. We have about a half an hour remaining. Enough time to sneak your call in here. You can't do it toll-free tonight, though, because the toll-free lines are broken at the moment. You'll have to use this number, 603-435-1105. That's 603-435-1105. Blockchain.com. I got that right. Blockchain.com. If you've been listening to the show for a while, you know we've been promoting blockchain.info. Same company. Blockchain.info is their site where you can go and get a free Bitcoin wallet tonight. And you, if you don't have a Bitcoin wallet yet, you should go and do that. Now, another question you might be having about Bitcoin as a business owner is, how do you receive Bitcoin from your customers? How do you set up, make it easy for your customers to pay with Bitcoin? Well, Blockchain.com has the solution. They actually have a brand new app that you can put on your smartphone or your Android device to accept Bitcoin safely and securely and for free. There's no terms of service. There's no ID requirements, no ridiculous sign-up process like you're maybe used to if you've tried some of the other merchant services providers in the Bitcoin world. Blockchain.com, totally different. You just go download the app from their Google Play Store or your Google Play Store and get started. Zero fees to accept Bitcoins if you use Blockchain.com's new merchant app. The nice thing about a merchant app is, you know, it's set up differently than your personal wallet. Like your personal wallet, if you were to give your employees access to that, then they'd be able to send your Bitcoin out of your personal wallet.
Not optimal.
Don't want to do that. So if you've got a merchant, you know, if you're in a physical location, point of sale kind of cash register situation, you need software to assist you with accepting Bitcoin. Blockchain.com is excited to announce they now have it. So check that out at blockchain.com. As we go back to your phone calls and thoughts, we're talking about the Cliven Bundy situation. You still could bring up something else, but that's really been ultimately what people have wanted to talk about here tonight. So we bring back John in Birmingham, who only had a moment right there before the break. John, I wanted to make sure you had a chance to get your thoughts out. So go ahead, please.
Yes, sir. Thank you. I just started listening to y'all the last few minutes before I called. And my take on it is the only real racism that can exist is institutional racism by government. You know, the government can make laws and things that say this person has to go to this bathroom, that person has to go to this bathroom, gets to sit this part. But everything else is preference. Now, here's my take on race. I think if you study history, you'll see that every human being is mixed, has mixed ancestry. Every single one of us, every country, our territory has been overran by a different group of people, the Europeans, Asians, everyone came from the...
That's a good point. People, it's more than meets the eye. Mark, didn't you do one of those DNA check things where they did the breakdown for you?
Yeah, but I think that... yes, I did.
Weren't you like 3% Indian, 2% black or something?
Some
like
other stuff. There's, no doubt about it. And I think that those whole things are sort of just somewhat superfluous. But I think that there's sort of overarching thing, and that is the sort of the major categories of race. I mean, I can hang out with a bunch of people who are, of similar skin tone than I am, and they're probably not going to note me as any different. But if I have much darker skin tone, then suddenly, like, there's a sort of a different aspect to it. But go ahead.
Okay, and but listen, I think because I don't know how y'all are, but I'm not real religious, for lack of a better term.
Alrighty.
And I think in 10,000 years, the human species will have evolved, and I don't even know if we'll look like how we look now. Like I think the human race is still evolving.
Sure.
And I think the dominant or majority race in 10,000 years might be half Asian, half European. It could be, genes are made by technology and so forth. I think we put too much stock in race because if you look historically, we're all mixed. And I think in 10,000 years, it won't even matter.
We're going to see more mixing. I mean, that much I think is true.
I think
time.
You might find that the human body goes out of fashion and relatively...
Robots. Yeah,
robots. People start taking on robot bodies and things like that. I mean, you're talking, at this point, humans can move robot arms with their brains. I can't imagine in 100 years whether or not... I mean, am I going to stick with the same old body if it's... I'm ethnically advantaged. If I can jump over a church, I mean, in my robot body, suddenly this... Yeah. Whole getting saved thing when I can just replace my parts doesn't matter anymore.
Okay, even though there's evidence out there that mankind is moving towards this augmentation with machine and that transhumanism, moving beyond the human body and moving into robotics and things like that, I think there's real strong evidence that that's the way things are going. Hopefully humans will be enlightened before they get into the robot bodies. Otherwise, it's just going to be, we're the titanium robots and you're just the aluminum robots. Then it'll the hate will still be there. It'll just change its form. That wouldn't surprise me.
Sure.
Any other thoughts you want to share?
Thank you so much. All I can say is I really have enjoyed listening to you guys for the last 30 minutes. I'm a hardcore anti-government. I don't really think the government has a role in society, because it's very nature. They have to take taxes from people at gunpoint to fund their projects, their bureaucracies. And so I think the ultimate movement will be, as we evolve, to literally have no government whatsoever.
I really think you found the right show, John. Before we let you go, I'd like to ask you, have you heard about the Free State Project?
I've heard in New Hampshire there's some folks moving up there or talking about moving up there to make New Hampshire free or have as small government as possible.
Yes, I'm glad that you've heard about that. That's actually why we moved. We moved from the South. We're originally, Mark and myself, are from Florida originally, and we moved up several years ago because I decided that the freedom movement needs to concentrate its people in one place in order to actually have an effect, in order to actually have a chance at turning things around and becoming, having a government become smaller rather than continuously growing larger. And we're seeing that it's working. We've got over 1,500 people that are here now in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. There are over 15,000 that are pledged to make the move to New Hampshire, and we're looking to get to 20,000 people. So I'd like to personally invite you to, when you get a chance, it sounds like you're on the road at the moment, but when you get a moment, go to freestateproject.org and check that out there. I don't know how in the world you're listening to us on the radio in Birmingham. Maybe it's a pirate radio station, because we don't have any official affiliates there. So if we're on the radio in Birmingham, and that's great to know. But if you want to find us online, you can do that at freetalklive.com. And I thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you.
Yes, sir.
Yep. 603-435-1105 is our number. Let's continue. Habu is on the line in Madison, listening to the Mike 92.1 WXXM there. Hey, Habu.
Yeah, hello, good evening.
Welcome.
I'm listening to your program, and One area that somewhat interested me, although I'm no expert in this, is the recent Cliven Bundy matter, although I haven't studied it in any detail. So my comments would be that from a layperson who's just superficially informed on the issue. You know, as far as Mr. Bundy's concerned, I'm just agnostic about him and his comments. And I don't think he should have all this time on the media, but any media is free to do what they want to do, just because it's just, you know, any ordinary person giving an opinion, and that's what it is. It isn't any kind of a proclamation of what he wants policy to be. It's just a citizen's take on matters, and that kind of varies across the population. So
yeah, I get
so
what you're saying, although Cliven Bundy is not your ordinary person. I mean, Cliven Bundy is an outstanding individual who actually stood up for his rights and the rights of everybody, ultimately. So the media is interested in trashing him. Many of the media, I should say, is interested.
Let me get to my point, please.
No, absolutely. I want to do
that. Yeah, fine. And your point is well taken. Yeah. But, you know, I'm hearing music. Are you getting
are.
Ready for
it? You are. So I'm going to put you on hold. But we will bring you back. And you have plenty of time for your point coming up here in moments. More with Habu, and your calls are welcome. In the remaining moments of Free Talk Live, which we're coming up on here shortly, the number 603-435-1105. This is Free Talk Live's Live Saturday Show. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Great news, pure water lovers. BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com has a special discount offer for all GCN listeners. You can't do better than a Big Berkey for economy. For only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. There's none better than a Big Berkey for emergency preparedness as a backup water source. And you just can't beat a Big Berkey to remove dangerous chlorine, all types of fluoride, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, parasites, and unhealthy byproducts from municipal water. Berkey water filter systems are even powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. For the gold standard in water filters, get a Big Berkey at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And all GCN listeners get 5% off all ceramic filter systems. For details, call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
Free Talk Live.
Oh, if only everyone were to behave in the way I think they should behave, humanity would be better off. Again, it's just trying to impose one's vision on others. You can't be humane to others by being inhumane in the first place. And by forcing them to behave or do things that you want them to do or think in the way that you want them to think, that's inhumane. You're not respecting their choices as a free, sovereign individual. And that's what liberty is all about. You respect the rights of others to live their lives, even in self-destructive ways that you think are a bad choice, so that in turn, you have the right to live your life in any way that you choose. That's what it's all about. And as soon as you violate that, as soon as you take a step into the world of initiating force on others, then anything's game. You validated that it's okay to use force to get your way as far as changing other people's behavior.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, Buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges start a conversation with your neighbor or your doctor or your family or your school. Now there's teachers and lawyers and business executives, and they all wear shiny badges and they all reject the state. Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges show the world that you reject coercion and aggression and oppression by the state. Shinybadges.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, moments remain here. No point in giving you the numbers at this point because phone lines are loaded up. If you're on the line, we're going to do our best to get to you and get your thoughts and calls on the air. If you don't get in tonight, no worries. We do another show tomorrow night, the Sunday edition. Maybe it's not on your local radio station. Some stations just take our Saturday show. So if you're not getting us 7 nights a week on your local talk station, but you're getting us at least one night, you could call up and thank the program director during the business week. Thank him or her for having Free Talk Live on the air, and then ask him real nicely if you can get more Free Talk Live. In the meantime, between that happening and or not, you can always go to freetalklive.com. You can get all kinds of archives and other features there completely free, unlike those other talk show hosts that charge you for their website. Go check out freetalklive.com.
If you go to coffee.freetalklive.com, you can get something free, a free pound of coffee. Not just any pound of coffee, delicious BuzzBox coffee. It's shade-grown, which means that if you get that kind of acid reflux thing from drinking your coffee, shade-grown coffee can help with that. It's it grows more slowly than the normal Robusto beans do. It's this is top 1% grade Arabica beans, completely organic. And it makes a real difference in the flavor. Also, coffee is a very absorbent crop, so you don't know what's going on in these third world countries as far as pesticides and leaded gas and things like that. So that might be an issue for you. And you can get a free pound. Try it out at coffee.freetalklive.com. Now, BuzzBox coffee is great, delicious, high-end coffee. And you can get that many places, especially on the internet. You can have that shipped to you. What you can't get is the sensibility that they have at BuzzBox Coffee. They want the people that grow their coffee to be taken well taken care of. So, and you know, they have programs for people entering their coffee co-op. You know, they teach them how to grow it sustainably, and that's a big concern for theirs. Also, they have a program for people that sell their coffee, like Free Talk Live, where we can offer microloans to people around the world. If we, for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, because you sign up for a subscription, you get the free pound, you can cancel at any time. If you don't cancel, you can continue to get your coffee there, and it's a great system. You never have to think about getting your coffee again. It's just delivered to you right to your door. You don't have to think about it. Then for every 10 people, we can offer a microloan that help people around the world get the things that they need in order to, you know, to have that hand up to be able to take care of their families instead of a handout. coffee.freetalklive.com.
All right, back to the phones and to Habu listening in Madison to the mic WXXM on 92.1. Hello, Habu. You are back on with plenty of time here to get your thoughts out.
Thanks for the reprieve.
Go ahead.
Thanks for the reprieve. But anyway, the bigger issue as I see it is, and especially with the libertarian movement, I don't care for the Hannitys, but with the libertarian movement is they've been, I think, rightly energized by this. But in my humble opinion, they don't seem to see, the claims of the natives there, the Native Americans like the Shoshone, who have had protests and also filed legal briefs against the BLM taking their land, and it's quite extensive. And the two people who are at the head of it are the Dan D-A-N-N sisters, who, one of whom has passed on,
yep,
but who have gotten awards. for fighting for not taking the money that was given by the federal government to negate their claim of the land that they controlled. So they were moved on.
Before you go on, Mark, are you familiar with this situation?
Only cursorily. I mean, I've heard about the Shoshone's claim. Also, the BLM has been awful to Native Americans, and the Dan Sisters. I am familiar with this. Cursorily, but it sounds like
I think many libertarians are outraged about how the government treats
this story
American
has
Indians.
Legs, and I don't know why. Is it inherent institutional racism? I don't know the answer to that.
Are you saying that that libertarians aren't giving the other story enough attention? I didn't even know about it.
Well, the fact that you don't know about it in a way confirms what our media is not telling. But even people who are committed as the Alex Joneses and all that have not run up this, this angle on the news.
I don't know if Alex Jones is a libertarian, but that's another conversation.
But even other people, let's say like you, since you haven't heard about it.
I don't hear about all the news in the world, but we have had Russell Means on the show in the past, and he's now passed away. But That's to point out that Free Talk Live is absolutely aware of some of these issues that that American Indians are facing.
Well, and even giving them, time, meaning that giving this aspect of the story some time, not because I brought it up, but it would seem to me that that would be a more original kind of challenge.
I get where you're coming from, and I thank you for bringing it up, because that's how, in a lot of ways, we find out about stuff. Yeah. The Free Talk Live, I don't know how new you are to the show, but Free Talk Live is a show where we literally open the phones every night. We bring a few things to the table to talk about, and a lot of the stuff we learn on this show comes from our callers and our listeners who submit content to the front page of our website at freetalklive.com. So if there was some sort of news piece that you wanted to submit to us, you could go to freetalklive.com, put it right there on our front page, and then other people can vote it up or down.
I'm not going to back off of it. I find this scalding editorial from Habu, and I'm going to internalize it. I think he's right. The difficulty we have here is people want to talk about what's hot right now, and I think you're right that we could, we could have stepped up in this situation and compared and contrast. Well, yeah, you could if you did a little more research on it.
Well, how would I research something I didn't even know about? Thank you, Habu, for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you, and thanks for the heads up. There's all kinds of news stories out there I don't know about. I only see what I happen to see. And if you want us to know about stuff, you have to call in or use the website. Really, if you can't expect us to know about all the same news stories that you know about. There's a lot out there. Let's continue here. We've got Dan listening in Franksville, Wisconsin to WXXL.
I wouldn't expect you to know. I mean, yeah, I can see it's not your fault. I mean, the guy's right about the media, you know what I mean? But that's a whole different talk. But it's funny, he was not talking about the Indians. So let's say this guy, say he was a racist even down there. What bothers me is just the fact that he's probably put in a position because of the economy that he can't pay these people. I'm not saying that that it's right to do that, or that the government isn't corrupt and stuff, but they're trying to paint him as a racist. Say he was. Why is he in such a desperate position that he can't give these people money? He's not a multimillionaire or everything where he can just throw money around.
He doesn't want to give them money, and I don't blame him for it. And whether he's a racist or not, I don't think he should give them money. Screw the feds.
The other thing is that before he says, this is my land, this and that, like this guy says before, this land has been stolen. I'm an absolutist as far as morality goes. And this guy, people are supporting because they want to be moral. But you have to at least have a talk with the people that originally owned that land. It isn't that long ago. They're waiting, especially like you were talking about Russell Means. This is the perfect time to put Ward Churchill on. He was the head of that band that Russell Means was a part of. I don't know if you guys ever heard of Ward Churchill, but just Google him, listen to his lecture where they're trying to smear him on 9/11, stuff he said about 9/11. But, that would be a perfect person to have on one of your shows one of these nights because it fits right in with this guy. I'm not saying the country should be given back to the Indians. It's almost impossible, but there should be dialogue with them people. They're open-minded, not going to say, we want all of America back, but there should be dialogue with the people that really own that land.
Thank you for your call tonight, Dan. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's go to Brian. He's in Huntsville listening to WBHP. Hey, Brian.
Good evening. And the concept of having my soul or my mind transferred to a robot Android or whatever, I really would not care to do that.
We'll put flowers on your grave.
Well, number one is because, do you want to be caused to crash or have your brain washed because you got a Microsoft automatic update?
I'm going Linux. I'm taking Mint.
Okay. Have a good night.
Oh, okay. You're welcome to go further on that point, but I get where you're coming from, and I thank you for the call tonight. I mean, I think it's right to be skeptical about this idea of modifying one's body.
The people that
machines.
Are going to take the first steps into consciousness into the machine world are likely people who have very few options as to where their consciousness sits today.
So like a quadriplegic or something
I mean, somebody who's going to die in the next few minutes.
Okay, sure.
You know, and they're going to try that or not try that. My concern would be, is a machine replicating their consciousness or are they in fact in there? And that's what I want to know.
How would you find out?
How would you ever find out? They've got machines painting paintings now. Pretty soon robots are going to be ballet dancing.
It's a fascinating topic. I wish we had more time to get into it. It's certainly an issue that we've discussed previously and will likely discuss again, the idea of transhumanism here on Free Talk Live. But for tonight, we're done. Mark will be back tomorrow with a live Sunday edition.
Indeed, I will.
And you can join him and his co-hosts at that time. You can join them on the phones. Maybe they'll have toll-free lines at that time, or maybe Mark's going to have to screen some calls tomorrow night.
I'm going on strike.
We'll see you tomorrow. Online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. Have yourself a great weekend.
A meme is not easy to define.
What is it?
But you know it when you see it.
Amazing.
Don't Tread on Meme.com proves that.
I feel so enlightened.
Don't Tread on Meme, M-E-M-E, helping you give the finger to our monetary system of deception by providing you with silver dime trading cards. Unlike today's dollar, they have value, and they look neat too.
Oh, would you look at those? Aren't those just swell?
Don't Tread on Meme.com. While you're browsing their numerous silver dime card designs, take time to download the easy-to-use Silver Calculator app. This simple piece of technology lets you know instantly, whether using iPhone or Android, just how much your silver coin is worth. Find out all the details at DontTreadOnMeme.com. Now accepting Bitcoin. Don't Tread on Meme, your path to a voluntary society with honest money. DontTreadOnMeme.com, serving you faster than the Fed prints money.
Have you ever wanted to help a hardworking person get their business off the ground? Then join me in enjoying some BuzzBox coffee. Let's make a difference, one cup at a time. Join us in helping people buy their own coffee farms through at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Free Talk Live coffee drinkers will truly change lives forever. To get the best coffee you've ever tasted, it's organic, shade grown, and top 1% Arabica grade. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. The first pound's free, just cover shipping.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
Radio VR.
Good morning and welcome to Radio VR. We're broadcasting from Washington, D.C. and around the world on voiceofrussia.com/US. I'm Rick Young. Today is Thursday, April 24th, 2014.
Radio VR News.
On a visit to Tokyo, President Obama is reassuring Japan that America will rally to its side if China uses force to grab a set of disputed islands. White House correspondent Mark Smith reports.
Last fall, China upped the ante by declaring an air defense zone over the islands.
It would be a profound mistake to continue to see escalation around this issue.
Here in Tokyo, the president told reporters if China seizes islands the Japanese now administer, the Joint Defense Treaty means America will respond. Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, through a translator, was reassured.
Changes of the status quo based on intimidation and coercion will not be condoned.
Obama says the issue's the same as in Ukraine, whether big countries can ignore the rule of law and bully their neighbors. Mark Smith with the president, Tokyo.
Georgia's new and controversial gun law expands where licensed gun owners can take their weapons. Correspondent Tim McGuire reports not everyone's happy about the law.
One gun control group from outside Georgia calls it the Guns Everywhere Law. The new measure allows gun owners to carry weapons into bars and under certain circumstances, schools, churches, and government buildings. Republican Governor Nathan Deal says the law is one of public safety.
So that people who follow the rules can protect themselves and their families from those who don't. Follow the rules.
Under the new law, religious leaders have the choice to allow or ban guns, and school boards would have the option of letting licensed employees carry weapons on school property. I'm Tim McGuire.
The U.S. Supreme Court says there are limits to the restitution that victims of child pornography can receive. Jerry Bodlander explains the decision.
In a 5-4 ruling, the justices threw out a judgment of nearly $3.4 million. It had been awarded to a woman whose videotaped rape by her uncle when she was a child was widely viewed on the internet. The justices said people who view child pornography can be ordered to pay restitution, but there has to be a limit based on what the person did and the victim's losses. Three justices said the way the law is written, the woman in this case, known as Amy, should get nothing. Justice Sonia Sotomayor said she should get the full $3.4 million. Jerry Bodlander, Washington.
Another court decision raising concerns, but as correspondent Emily Wagster Pettis reports, the Mississippi abortion law isn't expected to impact too many women, since very few abortions are performed after the midway point of a pregnancy.
Abortion access is already very limited in Mississippi. There's only one clinic that still performs abortions. And State Department of Health statistics show that only two of those were listed at 21 weeks or later. This new law probably will have very limited effect, but critics of it do say that it's unconstitutional.
The New York Police Department is getting a lesson in public relations and who controls social media. Warren Levinson tells us how the Twitter backlash blasted the NYPD.
When the department sent out a message asking Twitter users to tweet your photos with the hashtag MyNYPD, they were hoping to get a lot of feel-good pictures of civilians posing with patrol officers and maybe with police horses. But the overwhelming majority of snapshots were of a different kind of interaction. Cops wielding billy clubs on protesters, bloodying an 84-year-old pedestrian they were arresting for jaywalking. Changing hearts and minds one baton at a time, read a sarcastic caption from an Occupy Wall Street demonstrator. An NYPD spokeswoman insists the open and uncensored dialogue has been good for the city. Warren Levinson, New York.
Correspondent John Milbourne reports, even though the soldier previously known as Bradley has been granted a name change, Chelsea Manning will continue serving a 35-year prison sentence for leaking classified secrets at the all-male disciplinary barracks at Fort Leavenworth.
It's an all-male facility, and as far as the military is concerned, Manning is still a man. They can call inmate Chelsea Manning as opposed to previously referred to inmate Bradley Manning. It does not change where she's housed. It doesn't mean that she will now be eligible for any type of medical treatment. She's seeking counseling for her gender dysphoria and also hormone treatments.
And that's the news for Radio VR in Washington. I'm Rick Young.
Friends of local man Carl Brewster told reporters this week they are all absolutely at a loss as to how he is not completely depressed.
I've known Carl for years now, and he really is a great guy, you know, super nice. But honestly, I don't know how he doesn't go home and cry himself to sleep every night. I mean, walks dogs for a living and no one will ever date him. I really don't get it.
Saying that they were baffled at how their close friend managed to remain even moderately happy day in and day out given his life circumstances, sources confirmed they were regularly confronted with Carl's perplexingly gregarious and affable demeanor.
I mean, Carl's life really, really sucks, but somehow he manages to wave good morning to me every time I see him, and he always has this big smile on his face. Maybe he's on some kind of medication.
Things have always been really awful for Carl, but he's never really been depressed. I mean, I make three times as much money as him, and I'm totally miserable. Honestly, we all thought he would have killed himself by now, but he hasn't.
This is the Onion News Network.
And here.
Be
It's time for Off the Air Live. And here's your host, Cody O'Connor.
Hey guys, I'm back again. It is Off the Air Live, Saturday edition of the show this time around. Here is every Thursday and Saturday at 10 p.m. LRN.FM and on TalkSuperStation.com. Speaking of that whole station nonsense, let me open
this
the show with an announcement.
Live, we'll be featuring Afrin Pilch.
Just found this out yesterday. Off the Air Live is going to be expanding the Saturday show to 2 hours starting next Saturday. Isn't that cool? Yeah. Another whole hour of this nonsense, so we can always take your calls during that time at 774-314-7067, or you can Skype it Off the Air Live. Well, I'm in a weird headspace right now.
On cable TV,
I just a few minutes ago went to go on a beer run, and it got a little bit weird on my way back out to the car. What happened was I parked outside of this convenience store. I went and I purchased my 24-ounce Pilsner, right? And I came back, and there was another car parked next to me, but I thought it was my car because it looked the same, it had the same color, it was a sedan. So I just about got into the car, but the first thing I noticed was, like, wait a minute, there's a couple people in the car right now. Why are they in my car? That was my first notion. And my second thing that I perceived through my eyeballs is, wait a minute, she's definitely holding that guy's dick right now. This better not be my car. And luckily, I figured out that it wasn't way before I opened the door. Could you imagine how weird that would have been? And this is the thing that I didn't get, though. I'm pretty sure they looked over for a second in between locking of tongues and lips and penises and all the other juices, just to see that I was there and I was just a guy, any guy. I guess it didn't matter to them. They went back to their business. I got in the car because I was still processing at this point, like, what I had seen. I wasn't sure. I was like, well, maybe he spilled something. Me and my naivete, I was like, well, maybe she's wiping something off his pants. You know, maybe she's helping him with his seatbelt. maybe he has special needs. He doesn't know how to click it. Therefore, she's protecting him from getting a ticket. And I look over before I start the car, and she's leaned over. Looks like they're making out. And still, it takes me another, like, 5 seconds to go, okay, I see what's going on right now. And I think what it was is I wanted a really bad... If they for it not to be in, them simply the act of getting in a lucky in a convenience store parking lot, mostly because I've never gotten that lucky anywhere that public. It just hasn't happened to me before, so it's kind of a matter of jealousy.
So
like,
why can't
I want someone grab my shit while I'm just hanging out there? Right? No, it just never happens to me. It never does.
Those of you who go,
so I was just a little bit bummed out on my ride home.
And the Paracast.
I don't know what it is. How do you convince someone, like, well, now that we're here, is not, you know, active. Doesn't this seem
also,
like a romantic spot
the open
for you to grab my dick and jerk me all the way the fuck off?
iOS and OS,
I mean, there's so many better places that you could do that act, right? There's so many better places.
Yeah, it's not all versions.
You could go
open
out,
SSL.
Drive your car to a field,
it's,
you know, go to one of those drive-in movies. It's warm enough this week, right? Go to a drive-in movie. And no one's going
to
care
with something if it works.
If you're having full-on unprotected sex, I promise.
So again, it's just
no
really
one's
going to
care. Everyone's
really
too busy
no
watching the movie. All the lights are out. No one's looking at you.
You use,
if you're going to do it in a parking lot, though,
using,
I wouldn't do it in a small parking lot. This convenience store, literally, there are, I'm not kidding, there are two spaces.
On
the one that I was parked
on
in,
the other hand,
and then handicap parking,
concern,
which is where I didn't park.
With a smaller,
so that's why I initially thought,
site,
like, oh, well, I guess
there,
it's a handicap
could,
driver. He has a helper,
issue.
Someone needing help.
There are,
you know,
a lot of
okay, assisting with the seatbelt.
We don't think
nope.
The major social
I don't
media
get it. I'm
sites,
so,
Facebook,
were they just driving,
example,
and they were just so
are
turned
affected.
On by something?
So it's,
you know? What do these
really
guys say? Like, babe, we need to fuck
kind of
now. I like. I don't know how to.
Out there online
I don't know how to be sexy.
Out what to do?
Is that weird?
Which
like, I only know
change.
How to be. Now, just to mention here, if you do like have weird, a website hosted silly, by one of the hosting angry, providers, like Namesheap or iWeb, or one of those,
melancholy,
what you need to do is
nothing good. I don't know how to. I don't know how to pull off that persona. Of,
usually, by now here, they will have sent out a memo
see,
to you.
Sound,
as
I'm
a customer
I sound like a murderer.
What to do?
There's a fine line
a problem and how
to
fix
me,
it.
Anyways. Maybe
but
I'm perceiving it wrong, but there's a fine line between like Dexter-style serial killer
providers that
and
deal with
somebody being provocative.
So we're happy with that.
Because, like, when you're trying to convince a girl to perform
fellatio
on you.
Something like this.
You
so
don't word
you
it in a way where it's like a contract.
So
you're not asking permission so much. You're not
is
going like,
safe anymore?
Hey, can I ask for your hand?
Hopefully,
in?
Well, I had a friend who
you know what
to,
I'm going
to
use your hand for. It's called jerking my dick off. Can I ask for your hand in finishing the job, basically? You don't do that. You don't go, ma'am, could I request a favor from you? You don't do that either.
Look how easily passwords.
You don't say, hey, what do you think about next Tuesday night, we get totally naked and I penetrate you. What do you think about, like, you don't plan it out like it's a, you know, a time at the beach. That's not how it works. No, you go, babe, get over here. Let us fuck. Stuff like that. But it's like, wrong, then you sound a little bit rapey, don't you? So, the only difference
is
how attractive you are as a guy, right? See, that's where it's tough. And if you don't have the confidence,
but then again, if it's
like
smudged,
if you don't have that self-image where you believe yourself to be attractive,
because that's exactly how the hacker would get in. So there needs to be some things where some forms of login which just don't have any kind of password workaround. It's purely biometric, or there's some other method of authentication to know that you are you. But yeah, what we're seeing is
second.
That passwords.
Oh yeah, here
the
we are again.
Are
sorry,
way too
so
weak.
Yeah, the difference between having the self confidence of you know, if when you have the self confidence, you can go and you can be like, babe, get over here. We're gonna do some stuff, you know, and it's not like a request. You're not asking permission. It's kind of a command. But if the girl's way into you, like she doesn't care. She's like, oh my god, yes. Rips her clothes off to go to town. And it's weird because obviously I had that phase early on with Melinda, but we've been dating for over 4 years now. So like when you've been in a relationship for that many years, you don't do that as much, or at least I don't. Maybe I'm doing the relationship thing wrong. That could be a possibility, because like when we go to bed, it's not, we're not chock full of energy like some of these kids, you know? I'm not hyped up on Red Bull, like, just with a throbbing erection, swinging around and looking for some hole to put it in. Like, when I go to bed, the intent is to sleep for me, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know where these guys are getting this energy where they're just sitting in the car and they're like, we must fuck now. You know, I can muster up the energy to rub one out when I'm feeling a little bit backed up. But I my sexual energies need to be like, I need to turn that computer off and turn it back. I need to do a reboot. That's what it is. I need a sexual reboot. What I should do is read the Kama Sutra. I should go see a specialist, you know, so one of these, they can cover us both in oil. They can do some chants and mantras. They can put us under hypnotic spells. And then we're incredibly turned on because there's beads everywhere and incense. And we can pretend like it's that scene from 300 with all the Persians with jewels hanging from their tits. Maybe that's the solution. I don't know. But it kind of dawned on me when I was in the convenience store seeing that. Just like, man, I need to do stuff in a public place. That needs to be somewhere on my bucket list. The most public place where I've had sex, it wasn't really a public place, but it was in front of people without them knowing. What happened is a couple summers ago, me and Melinda, we were in a tent for the night with two friends of ours, and they were sleeping, I think. And then we had quiet sex, that whole thing where, like, it was spooning, and then it got a little bit more than spooning. Nobody ever found out, and that was the end of it. But in a parking lot, that takes balls. And not blue balls, ladies and gentlemen. This is Off the Air Live Saturday edition. More coming up. Let's
MeowBit is free software from the Freedom Fiends that allows you to effortlessly view .bit websites. MeowBit works on all browsers. .bit is a new type of web address that's not controlled by any government or corporation. And we'll show you how to register a .bit domain today using a few cents worth of Namecoin. If anyone ever shuts down your .com website, users will still be able to get to your site using your .bit address in our free software, MeowBit. Go to meowbit.com. That's MEOWBIT.com.
My name is Angel Rach. I'm a mother of two teenage children, and I fought all the way to the Supreme Court for the right to use the medicine that saved my life. I've been permanently disabled for 10 years, with an inoperable brain tumor, wasting syndrome, and several other serious conditions. For 4 years, I was in a wheelchair, in so much pain, I couldn't even hug my kids. The hardest part was looking in their eyes and seeing how much they were suffering because of my medical condition. The medicine that gave me my life back and gave my kids their mom back was cannabis, also known as medical marijuana. With medical marijuana, I can walk, maintain my weight, and I can be a mom. Without it, my doctors believe that I would die. To learn more about medical marijuana, contact Marijuana Policy Project at 1-877-JOIN-MPP or on the web at mpp.org.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's Keene, New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat. All free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are, 1, let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.LRN.FM. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.LRN.FM. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please do your online shopping at shop.LRN.FM.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
6 drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Give us a call at 774-314-7067 or Skype Off the Air Live. Here's Cody.
So the closest thing that I can do towards a sexual proposition is by making innuendos during everyday situations that I know will never amount to anything ever. Like a lot of the time, me and Melinda will be driving and we'll almost get in a near accident. So already her headspace is, oh, we're going to die. I'm freaked out. I'm in a bad mood. This is not good. It's not going to be good for me. And then what do? In my geniusness, I go, I'd love to rear-end you right now. I mean, and I know it's not going to work. Like, she's said to me multiple occasions, she's like, every time you make one of these jokes, there is a exponentially less of a chance that you're ever going to have sex. The only time it ever really works out, like, really well is, like, you watch a movie, you cuddle, and then there's that unspoken, like, you start rubbing and it gets into the good zone. But that's like my best technique right now. Hey, Garrett Fox, what's going on, man?
What's going on, brother?
Haven't talked to you since Porkfest? Has it been that long?
It sounds about right. We've been dabbling on the Facey space a little bit there.
That's about it. What's on your mind tonight?
Well, I just wanted to holler at you real quick before all the Nathans called in.
Yeah, so we're talking about sex right now. Do you have like a let's get a little bit personal. Do you have like a technique that always works, that like always gets you laid?
Well, it's funny that I finally found a Saturday night to call into your show. It didn't work out so much tonight. The techniques.
So plan B was call into this show, basically. Well, if I'm not getting laid, I've already seen Firefly enough times. I might as well call into Otel.
I mean, there's Star Trek if you want to get into that, but no. No, just call into Cody's show. It's going to be a good time. I've been ready for the microphone, though.
Okay, well, it's a pretty good third step. But what do you usually do when it does work out for you?
Oh, well, I like to talk to the pussy. I like to make sure it's sobbing wet a little bit before I even get started on, making sure I get there. I like to make sure the vagina is on its way, if I can be so honest.
Right. So do you ever do like the romantic stuff, like bunch of roses on a bed, because that can look pretty serial killery too, can it?
Well, I guess so, yeah.
If you do it wrong.
Well, if you ever want to, murder somebody, yeah, just lead them in with petals of roses and stuff.
I don't know. Like, I feel like I've seen so many movies where whenever somebody is about to die, what the bad guy will do, I remember this from like Daredevil, the bad guy was this big, burly black dude. And whenever somebody was about to die, he'd go up to him, he'd pat him on the chest, put a little flower in his breast pocket, and then walk away. And then later on, they would mysteriously be covered in blood and dead.
What the hell was that? I never saw that. You know what? I want to talk to you about like television show entertainment. I think